Oh, we're alive! Oh, wow.
What?
Where okay. are we
over here?
Great.
Okay.
Oh, I'm so tall. The tallest I've ever been.
Oh, do I need to do a horse stance?
No, you can do it. Great. If you want to sit down, I don't know.
Okay,
we didn't check okay, this before we started.
We're checking in now, man.
Yeah, we look
just
great.
A smidge, so we're sitting.
Yeah, this looks neater.
Yeah. Yeah.
Good job.
Hi, everybody that is tuned in to us. Welcome to another extra super duper special episode of the Bottlecap Brigade. This is part two of the one-shot entitled Cthaeh. I am your host, Sam McPenis Gates.
Woo!
And
so step daddy.
All of our wonderful players.
Hashtag penis gate.
God damn it.
Big conspiracy.
Scandal of the century.
I didn't write...
It's every time.
I didn't write a joke today, as is tradition. I just wanted to point out that I stole most of this from Patrick Rothfuss, and I even though I know that he delays the third book every time he hears it said, put out the third book.
Well said.
Yeah, thank you.
Articulated well.
Yeah, really good.
Also fair use, so legally he can't sue for you stealing it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cthaeh,
yeah.
Cthaeh, Cthaeh.
All you have to say is fair use. And HIPAA, I guess, that's all you have to do.
HIPAA says I'm safe. Yeah, so let's introduce today's friendos. First up, there's no one kinder than Miranda Hikilla.
Thank you.
Yeah. secondly, that's I know four. Secondly, I don't know if you all knew this, but the nicest person in the room is Austin Townend.
It's confusing.
That's confusing.
What happens when an unstoppable force meets an immovable object?
Miranda wins every time.
It's all over. There.
Next, Kat Lazarga isn't here. I said her last name wrong.
Big ups.
I was gonna say Lazarga. I was gonna say Kat that you were the epitome of greatness, but you're not here to hear that.
So greatness revoked.
You're still great.
Yeah.
Next, I can't overstate how great this guy is. It's Austin Von Dahl.
Oh no. Good thing I'm here.
I'm not good at giving compliments.
That was close.
Yeah.
You're doing great.
Last but certainly not least, we have our amazing friend back as a guest, and he is the only person that can make me even somewhat interested in baseball. It's Matthew Melton.
Come on, look at this guy.
Matt, would you like to plug some pluggables as one does on a podcast in which you plug?
Do something weird, like not even your stuff.
Okay. I barely do my stuff, so like you're asking me to do something else. I don't know.
Plug your shit.
Check out Loki on.
That's right. It's really great. You guys seen this? So I co-host a baseball podcast with my best friend Jimmy. It's called That Baseball Show. Anywhere you find your podcast, probably wherever you find anything you listen to, you can find us. It's only marginally about baseball, more about sports culture, pop culture, that sort of thing, and it occasionally intersects with the game of baseball. So there you go. If that's an elevator pitch that's of interest to you, check it out.
Fuck the Olympics. Listen to that.
If you're watching us, you've already said that because the opening ceremonies are happening right now, or they were taped and they're being played now. So you don't need any of that. You just need us.
No one cares about the Olympics.
I actually didn't even realize.
No, that's great. Austin. Von Johnson, do you have something you'd like to tell everyone?
Heck yeah. So, everyone that's tuned in right now, thank you so much. We are in the process of redesigning our Patreon. There will be a new and improved Patreon launch happening in August, so August 1st. You can see all new tiers. You're going to see some new rewards for our patrons. Now, of course, we've also had a lot of great support from you guys, up until this point. And some of you have received your special gift already. Mm-hmm. We have more special gifts going out to all of the folks that have been, so graciously supporting us over the past year and a freaking half.
What?
Hot damn. Thank you all so much for your support on Patreon. Stay tuned for a completely new and improved Patreon experience from the Bottle Cap Brigade.
Bam.
Wow.
Damn.
Amen.
What a...
Scrap.
Flap.
Flap. Did I do that right?
Yeah, it was great.
You got okay. so many.
You can't do it wrong.
So many toe beans in there.
Yeah. So also because of the fact that this is an extra special one shot, I would assume that everyone would watch part one before watching part two. One would hope. But if we could just really quickly go around and reintroduce our characters really quickly, give our a brief description of who you are and what the fuck is going on with your character, that would be cool. Do you want to start?
I'd be happy to. I'm playing Kenvoth Crushbone, half-orc barbarian, eldest son of Susan Crushbone, the chieftain of the Crushbone tribe, and a tribe of orcs that I did not actually give a name to, because it doesn't matter, don't worry about it.
Yeah.
And we just out here chilling.
Wonderful.
I panicked there at the end.
I mean,
that's a solid panic line, though. I'm just out here chilling.
What else are you going to do when the world's about to end?
Just come out here chill.
Chill the fuck.
Just gotta chill out.
That's my thing.
Yep. Yeah.
Great. Austin?
Yeah, I play Cindy Brainerd. She is a human wizard, and she is exhausted. From putting up with and cleaning up after all these little ungrateful shits. She's an alcoholic, but only drinks because of stress. And she, if you've ever seen Orange County, she the movie from like 2003, she is very similar to Catherine O'Hara's character in that film. So check that out. Real quick, just pause this YouTube, go
stop
watch
this.
That, and then it'll make sense. It's not worth it. Just this is just D&D.
Do go watch that, though. It's a very good movie.
It is.
I said it last time, but it's a quality movie.
Freaking yeah. good. Like, oh, and it's aged so well.
Okay, okay, good.
You don't say that often.
No.
Right?
Yeah. Yeah. So.
Well, proud of you.
Okay.
That's a lot. That's a lot. Austin, number two.
Yeah, I'm using this as an opportunity to remember how I talk.
Really good. Get some reps in right now. That's good. Take some swings.
Oh, I'm missing a button.
Oh, no, not the buttons!
The button!
I'm Rudeus Maximilian, and I am a tiefling and a cleric, and I think I'm very eccentric and possibly confused on my sexuality, among other things. And I think it's great.
Search and explore.
I'm figuring it out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Totally.
That's my highlight.
I mean, at least you have one. You
know? I think we joke that I'm all European, so it could be any country. Sometimes it could be anything. Actually, at this
French,
point.
Some German,
yeah,
Dutch.
Some German,
some
yeah.
Doss ends up in there, which could yeah. be anybody, really.
Yeah,
some cool. German, there's some Dutch.
Yeah, right.
Russian would probably somehow like Eastern European.
Das Eastern European.
Somewhere cold and with a lot of death metal.
Yes.
That's all that. All
drinks
that we
the blood.
Yeah,
it's for my victims.
Miranda.
I am Talon Stray. I am a 6 foot tall catfolk, black, well oiled skin, kind of wearing sort of like trench coat, almost like this. She has a bum leg, but her whole right leg, she doesn't have a leg, but it's robotics, so when you are kind of around her, if it's sort of quiet, you can hear a little tinkering happening in her leg. She walks with a black cane with a dragon head on the top. She's quite tough. She's a fighter, and she's quite serious and stoic as well, but she can handle her shit and protect those that she needs to.
Thank you, Miranda, for describing how you look and being the only one who did so. Like, oh shit!
Very helpful.
God damn it!
In the world that we're trying.
Oh,
to
Oh, and she wears a mask like the one I'm wearing here, so at night she has extra dark vision.
That's dope.
Cindy has a robot arm and these fancy goggles that have little like and things that like
yeah.
can put shit over.
Arm.
Yeah, it's
the one clamper.
It's like one of those. It's literally like the robot, the fucking like in an assembly line is what you did.
Yes, it's actually a product you can buy. That's how I found that for the thumbnail. It's a one-arm robot thing that you can buy and grab stuff.
Check out all of Austin's amazing thumbnail work on our YouTube channel, youtube.com/thebottlecapbrigade.
And check out his thumbnails.
And check out his thumb work.
They're fucked up.
For the thumbnails, stay for the show.
Austin hasn't trimmed his thumbnails in 3 years.
Hey-o.
That's a little known fact.
So. No, you do have a drum set, but it's just kind of far away.
Yep, it does.
We'll do that next time.
All right, so let's begin. So after leaving Aramor, a small community in the northern forest of Astine, the party finds itself traveling to the catacombs of the royal family. With your brand new city and the royal family in peril, Aramor is in ruins, and the native population of the Northwoods is skeptical at best of your colonizing presence. You all have what will likely be the last opportunity to get to the bottom of what is causing the unrest and social disturbance and magical uneasiness in Magna. After fighting a number of fiends and corpse flowers and your short adventure creatures that essentially are taking some of the citizens of the Northwoods and turning them into zombies, you've stumbled over the now held corpse of a small halfling. Who was it that casted Old Person?
I cast Old Person.
Okay. Held up currently by Cindy. You're on the path to the catacombs. Your journey so far has taken about 6 hours from the beginning in Aramor. And you probably have about another 18-hour journey left to go to the catacombs. What would we all like to do? And to also, I guess, to set up the scene, too. You all, Cindy, you have set up a Hold Person on the poor halfling. You're kind of all walking away from him at this point.
We left the halfling.
You started to walk away, certainly.
And we're walking, to clarify.
Talon's
some of us are in
stallion.
A light jog.
Yeah, there's Bally and the Stallion that Talon is riding, and Ken, you have a contraption.
Oh, fuck.
Do you have a name for it?
I don't, but yeah, I
what would you like to name it?
It will reveal itself, ooh. I think, on this episode. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Would you like to describe
all great
it?
Orc machinery and
yes.
weapons, it must find its purpose,
yes,
and
it will
be named
you.
That.
It's a hand crankable. Scooter.
It's essentially a fantasy / steampunk big wheel, like an adult
right.
big wheel, only the pedals are up here, so our guy Ken gets sort of a bicep workout.
Our boy!
While he's doing it, and it's got I feel like it's got wings.
Yeah, it has
they're
wings.
Almost
that don't
more
do anything.
For show.
Yeah, more
they
for balance.
Really don't. Maybe I said they're for balance,
yeah.
but they're it's a little. It's everything you can do to just keep it going,
and
but
somehow
he does.
It doesn't tire you out.
Somehow not.
Yeah.
Kenneth can go for days.
Yeah. So, and you like to do tricks on it. So that's kind of the you two are walking. You two are kind of riding off to the side
at a slow,
yeah.
sort of a light workout pace,
getting ready to leave the scene of.
Oh yeah, we do have
could
our horses.
Be a horrid crime.
We're on
so.
Horses. You're on the old one.
Yeah.
And you gave me the normal one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I called her mediocre.
At best.
Needy for short.
Needy.
Another thing that's happened here is, Cindy, you found a journal on the body of the halfling that was incapacitated. He was uneasy, a little bit on edge, I think we could say.
Yeah, he was crazy.
He's
yeah.
having a traumatic episode.
Yeah.
That's how you describe it.
At best.
Yeah.
And maybe a full-on meltdown. But
yeah.
Would you like to just refresh everyone on what was in that journal?
You know, I just can't get this out of my head.
Yeah, read it again.
It's just... it says, the people are becoming more and more restless. We never could have expected it would get this bad. The lack of action by the council isn't much of a surprise. But you'd think that when the entire aqueduct floods, they would at least care enough to send someone to investigate. I totally identify with this. I just want to say it.
Did you write
you'd
that?
Think, oh, no, it wasn't me. This is totally taking off his magically held body. Hopefully, it was just a freak accident. I woke up... to a loud oh, this is a different different date. So that date, this is kind of odd. The date on here kind of coincides with when Nista died. So that's a thing. Anyway, a few days later, goes on to say, I woke up to a loud explosion last night. We've all been there. It sounded like it came from the docks, but we haven't had runners all morning, so nobody really knows what's going on. I can hear screaming in the distance. Oh, God.
I'm like Isaac Boston.
They're at the gates. The streets are full of crimson water. That's blood, right? That's crimson.
Would
anyway.
It be anything else?
Bloody water.
It could be vine.
They'll be able to swim soon.
I
just...
See, like
it
that.
Vibes. Okay.
Don't
somebody
like to swim?
Find their paper boat. Am I right? Oh, God. She's dead. It's my fault. She's dead. Okay. That's all that said. It's just in that entry.
It's a really good journal entry.
Yeah. Okay. And now it just says Cthaeh over and over and over and over again. Cthaeh. This is very hard to say.
Yeah. Free form.
Cthaeh. And then here it is again, but this time it's all capitalized. This is, and again all capital. Oh, C.
I wonder what they're going to write.
T.
Oh.
H.
Where's this going?
A. Who knows?
What a mystery.
E, and it's a fucking H. It's Cthaeh again. Okay, fine.
Yeah.
So that's not good. Right now,
I'm starting to think our guy might be nuts.
Yeah, a little possessed.
He's
and
very good poetry.
I mean, for a while at the end there, it got a little abstract. I would say single letters and whatnot, but
oh my God,
creative.
Yeah, you know, I mean, it's
the
not
only
my
compliment that means nothing.
It's not my thing, but like I appreciate the people like it. You
like,
know what I mean?
I think y'all's very creative.
All right, well. Yeah, I mean, thanks. Uh-huh. Got you know, something.
That's
in
my
your...
new thing.
Uh-huh. Okay, that's your new thing. Okay.
Like, check it out, Todden. Uh-huh.
Do you have to make the sound every time, too? Is it a package deal?
What sound?
You know, so do it again. So tell me I'm a creative again.
Yours very creative.
Uh-huh. Okay, yeah, sure. Got it.
Take
no,
fast,
no further questions.
Time.
Yeah. That's just going to happen every time.
Wonderful.
Huh?
Yes.
Yeah, great. Cool. It's a cool new trick.
Should we check on the man with the journal?
I don't know. Should we kill him?
Yes.
Okay.
Fuck.
I just wasn't sure, you know, because it you'd think, do we just leave him and let things
happen? Talon's just
going to
hop off the horse and just...
Just
fuck,
run
she's
up.
Going in.
Okay.
Talon,
run, go ahead and roll an attack roll, I guess, just to... I mean, you can't really miss.
Yeah, held person.
As long as you don't not want it.
24.
Okay, how do you want to... Describe how you want to murder this held
captain. Sam always changes it. You want to kill him? Okay, tell us how you murder him, you jerk.
Well, you hit, so what's
Talon will kind of hop off the horse, sort of like walk from behind so the halfling doesn't see it, and then just very quickly and smoothly from behind just cut the
okay.
neck.
Behind, okay, that's...
As you're kind of walking up behind, you're not really being super stealthy about it. He sees you even though he's held, and you can see his eyes kind of start to dart back and forth as you kind of pull your dagger out, and he kind of starts to smile blissfully, like before you end his life. Roll a constitution saving throw for me as well.
Oof. Are we fucking up the session?
No. Not yet.
You always so
nice
win, Miranda. It turns out that he's
because I always play such like joyful, like woohoo characters, and then it's like when I get the option,
one shots,
like,
you're like, let's fucking kill all this.
Yeah. Give me that fantasy. God. 7.
Okay. So
the fantasy we deserve is the fantasy we need.
Let me find. I didn't expect to have to do this.
Wait, I might get a thing where I get a roll again. Because I'm level 20.
Let me know. We'll see who wins.
Also, while we're looking things up, I feel like my favorite part about this one shot is that in true D&D fashion, it took more than one night.
Yeah.
Every time you do one shot.
I've literally never played a one shot that is finished, started, and concluded in one evening.
That's how I know I wrote it.
We're right on course, is what I'm saying.
Okay. Wow, that's wild. This could be worse. So feel free to look that up, but you don't have to worry about it too much. And I'll let you kind of choose what this manifests itself at. But as this halfling dies, and you can kind of see the whites of his eyes become more prevalent as his pupils roll back in the back of his head, he sinks into almost a happiness. And you're the only ones that sees this, but kind of a bit of a wisp of like purplish air comes out of his mouth, and it almost like it has a life of its own, kind of seeps into your nostrils and gets into your brain. And now for the next
10 because I do get to add an extra chunk of my proficiency, but I don't know if that changes anything.
You still failed. Yeah. Okay. For the next 3 days, which is as long as this is going to happen, you feel compelled to repeat a specific activity over and over, such as like washing your hands, praying, counting coins.
Can I be eating an apple?
You get OCD.
Can I eat an apple over and over again?
Yeah.
Great.
Certainly.
How many apples do you have?
How many?
I have
that is
a whole motherfucking
question.
Bag of endless apples.
Okay. it is endless? Is that in your inventory?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, she chose her magical item, which was endless bag of apples.
Yeah. We're going to say, you know what? I'm just going to roll a d20,
okay.
And that's how many apples you have in your bag. You have one.
You ate all the apples?
So what that tells me is that you already had that thing.
For a while.
Just compulsively eating apples.
I already was eating apples.
We were saving dust.
All right. It'll be with an apple.
I think if you don't eat apples, you probably get pretty cranky.
Okay.
So,
Oh no, not Talon cranky.
What does that look like though? Do you think she's like smiling?
Oh, yeah, maybe it's like a reverse thing.
Who knows?
Oh, yeah, play the opposite.
It's like, if she's nice, be scared.
Wonderful.
Okay, so we kill the guy.
Yeah, he's dead. His corpse now bleeding on the ground. Yeah. The hold person spell has lost effect. He's limp. He's shit himself. And is just laying off to the side of the road where he was held.
So should we kill him? Oh, fuck. Well, that's... Okay.
Yeah, that happened so fast.
Woo!
We barely said that.
Yeah.
He's dead now.
Okay.
Just saying, you move very quick.
I'm efficient.
You guys are level 20.
So. Okay, well...
Well, yeah,
we couldn't even see her.
Yeah.
Anyways, I guess we just go now, right?
Wait!
What?
You forgot the most important thing!
Oh my god.
We must voot his body!
What is
it doesn't
that?
Need rooting.
We need to... No, we need to voot him.
Are
you
saying...
No,
voot him.
Check every nook and cranny and voot him.
Well, if you want to check his crannies, then...
Oh, dibsies!
Okay, guys.
I'm gonna hop off and loot him.
Okay. So as you... no one needs to roll for this. As you go and inspect the corpse, you find 2 gold coins that you know that are... they're like... coins that were used in a fire before the entire half of the continent flooded. And it's not worth much. It was like $2, right?
It's like old money, though.
Yeah, old money that's not really good anymore.
I would like to buy it.
Pretty much everything's
dead.
Yeah, it's made of metal.
Yeah.
One is silver and the other is like.
But I'm like, whoopsie-daisies!
Yeah.
Let's put that in your mouth, goddammit! And I run over and I press the digitation of the money.
Okay. Yeah.
to clean the money. You don't put money in your mouth.
Wait.
God,
sorry.
I take my eyes off you for 2 fucking seconds.
Sorry. Are you using prestidigitation as like hand sanitizer?
Basically,
it makes
yes.
It look clean. But
as like a Clorox wipe.
It's like everybody, put your hands out.
You put the wipe inside your body in a way. God. Just kind of rub it in there.
I mean, it's a good idea. I'm not saying it's a bad idea. I just wanted to be clear about what was happening.
That's exactly what's happening.
Well,
I could probably help.
I'm a helicopter mom.
You just give a little lick and then press the digitation in the face. You got a little smudge there.
You don't get sick from that. You also find this halfling has been surviving off the land for who knows how long. He really has nothing left to his name other than tattered clothes. You find that he has pooped in his pants as a result of Talon, killing
him. That's fair.
There's the poop.
He would have done it anyway after death.
Yeah, it's not solid.
Wait, did he do it after death?
Yeah.
What color?
Oh, you just answer it. I don't even have to investigate this.
No,
because I will.
I mean, no, you all kind of saw it happen.
God.
But it's not solid, it's brownish. Mostly water and really gross berries that made him sick.
He had berries?
He was eating berries from the forest, foraging.
Please don't harvest the uneaten berries out of his deep.
Don't eat those, Rudeus!
He only had DOS coins!
Don't eat berries! Those are bad berries. God, can we just go now, please?
Yeah, I'm on board with that, actually. I don't want to watch this dude eat berries that were out of doo-doo, so I'm ready to get moving.
Onward, then.
Should we move him?
I mean...
It's on the path.
God damn it.
Should we bury him?
Maybe be a warning sign to those behind us to not continue forward.
That's fucking scary! We should do that!
Whatever you guys want to do, just do it. We gotta get going.
I'm not doing anything. I'm on my horse already, so...
I know a very big, strong man that could help!
Eating apples so slowly.
Huh?
I'll call him over! Me! Ooh!
Oh. Yeah, well, yeah, that's actually better for me, so...
Okay, well...
I'll bury him!
Well, you said you were the big, strong guy, so...
It wasn't Joe!
Oh, okay. Hard to tell with you. Is that... That's Spanish?
Because I'm foreign!
Well, it's not that you, because you're foreign, it's that I just don't know, like, I couldn't even be racist, you know what I mean? Because I don't know where you're, like, does that make sense?
I think it's racist that you could not discern what racist I am!
Well...
Race is a construct?
Well, let's be clear about that.
I'm mid-Eastern European-ish Southern American.
You want to throw a West in there to collect the whole set?
My mother was Italian.
All right. That's awesome. I mean, I don't know. Like, seems like most everything is
okay. Bye, everybody. Bye, bye. I'm like, and Cindy's starting to ride off. Okay, bye. Well, I'm going. Okay,
yeah.
Bye.
Are you falling?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm fine with that.
Okay, you're falling.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm like, that's a big load off my shoulders.
Gross. What are you doing?
I would like to bury him.
Okay.
I'm saying this to myself.
Yeah, yeah. You're standing in the middle of the road.
Bury him,
just
Rudeus.
To be clear and to set the scene, Talon, Cindy, Ken, you all on
like
your,
slowly. Like I'm not like
thing,
warp
kind of
nine
saunter
over here.
Away.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Rudy, you say in the middle of the road, I'm going to bury him.
That's exactly me.
Spot yeah. on.
And
doesn't
then,
matter anymore.
Yeah. Like, would you go ahead and just roll? Fuck. I guess...
roll fuck with advantage.
Roll a sleight of hand. And do you have anything to do with?
I'm actually not going to bury him.
Okay.
I would like them to start to leave, and then I would like to cast a spell.
Okay, they walk away. You're going to have to roll like a stealth check. Do a stealth.
That's my best stat!
You're level 20.
It's a plus a zero, because I'm Italian now.
It's a plus a zero.
I threw it.
Oh, it's a good
drink.
Roll.
Do we still keep it, or do I reroll?
Reroll.
It was pretty good.
Fucking
do you still have plus zero to dex and intelligence? Shh,
you're level 20.
I put it in the things that matter.
Okay.
I have a plus zero to charisma.
That is worse.
Weird.
I do, actually, now that I think about it.
No, I rolled a three.
Okay.
And I ended with a three.
Okay, they all see you do this.
Okay.
Okay, we're going!
I'm like, Des, I have no
go.
Idea! I'm like,
you certainly don't think that they can see you.
Yeah, I'm like, I'm going to do the nutty!
The nutty?
That sounds worse.
I'm
yeah.
sorry.
You want to try that again or no?
If you fuck that, that corpse,
move faster, folks.
You are so grounded!
And you guys all don't think, you all know that he doesn't think that you can see him. Like,
right.
This so fits the character. I'm the dumbest healer of the party ever. My intelligence is 10.
As I'm pedaling off, I go, Rudeus, it will work better if you stop narrating.
Who's dust that?
I'm going to cast Speak with Dead.
Okay.
Using my last third level spell.
Sure. Sure. You can ask vague questions. You can ask questions, but it'll give you vague answers. So, and I think
games.
Do you get three or five?
Questions?
Yeah.
Five.
Okay. Yeah, so.
Nobody knows what a new inline.
As you cast that, it kind of suspends himself in the air with your ethereal magic that flows through its body. And he floats up there, his eyes open, and they just kind of, he rolls his eyes because he's kind of alive again and he really doesn't want
to. And I like cut his, like sliced yeah, his magic his, to like throw his kinda, on his body.
Yeah, girl.
Nice.
I've been needing a friend for a long time.
And he just kind of, without opening his mouth, he speaks, what do you want?
So like, how do we do this? Like, what's going on?
That was two questions.
Fuck! It was kind of one blended into two.
You have three questions left to answer those questions. You can answer. You can ask me five questions.
I like when you talk. It's a relationship.
Okay.
It's kind of a back and forth thing.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Why? Okay, well, so what's with the Cthaeh thing?
The Cthaeh is powerful.
And that's what, well, that's in the question, so I won't say it. I'm very good at this.
My question is more of a comment.
You look great. It's a bit bad around the neck.
Some black goop just kind of...
Oh, I'll get that.
It actually hits you in the face a little bit. Just a little bit.
Oh! I got that. Okay, what should I be worried about?
The Cthaeh.
Yeah, this is very helpful. Well, since no one can see me, I have one last question.
We're all like looking back.
How good do I look in this suit?
Honestly?
You ask questions too! This is a working back and forth relationship!
You look fine. And then he collapses down to the ground, and his lifeless corpse cripples into, like, just a pile of bones and blood.
God.
And black and poop. Like, oh, black God. Shit from his throat and poop.
Okay.
It yeah. smells awful.
It's gross.
Well, you really got that guy good if he's shitting from his throat.
Also, roll it up.
That's some level 20 assassination
is there anything
right
like
there.
The black stuff in my
roll
throat. Yeah, let's do it.
That would have been an 18. You saw that, right? And then it went to a 2.
Okay. Oh, no!
Hold on.
You're going to have a lot.
I'm pretty bad at this, too. So I got a 6.
I didn't think I'd have to use that.
Twice, okay.
Twice.
No, wait, I gotta go visit the corpse too now.
Yeah, I OCD as well.
Okay, you have disadvantage on ability checks for the next
session.
I don't want to do that. You have disadvantage on ability checks for the next half of a day.
Ask you when it's been
happening. I'll let you know.
Okay.
I
just want to.
The reason that you have disadvantage on ability checks is because you're now experiencing vivid hallucinations.
Oh, that usually.
Yeah.
Goes hand in hand.
And these can be anything from seeing scary demons and monsters coming out of the ground behind you to seeing puppies and kittens licking your face. It can be literally anything.
Is this up to me?
Yes.
Fun.
Yep. All right, so that all happened. What now?
Okay, I guess I'm starting to follow down the road.
Okay, you want to follow
like
now?
Yeah. Like
okay.
Weird, like...
Are you done with your date?
Why is the tree talking?
Oh my fucking God.
It's
We're going!
Okay, so as you, as you all travel down the road, you know, the path, it gets a little bit less well-worn as you continue on. It looks like you're kind of coming off of some of the trade paths that were set up by some of the native folk in northern Astine. There's a dog. Get out of here.
Yes.
Sorry, go on. Okay. So it looks like you're getting off of some of the standard traveling paths from some of the locals. About an hour and a half later, you kind of hear a bit of a growl and something off to the north of the path, so on your right-hand side. And you're traveling at like a fairly normal pace, so it kind of comes and goes as you pass it. You just hear a...
I would like to try to perceive where that is and what it is.
Okay, yeah, just roll a perception check. Can I help you?
It's not great.
Do you guys hear the ocean?
That's a 10.
Okay.
Does it sound more animal, or does it literally sound like a person doing it?
It kind of roll a perception check.
Okay. It makes absolutely no difference. Does animal, because I have the same bonus, can I roll animal handling?
It's not an animal.
Okay, perception it is. Yeah.
15.
Okay.
So now one, baby.
Cheers. You have no fucking clue. Nope. That's a good time to roll that one. Talon, you hear off to the side what sounds kind of like an orc casting spells, which is something that you haven't really come across too often in all of your travels. But it sounds, just from what you can hear, that it's maybe 60 yards away from the path, and he is getting his ass kicked.
This cat's character.
Oh, shit. If I had a guess, I think one of your kind, an orc, is about 60 yards. Sounds like he's getting his ass kicked. We have shit to do. We should just ignore it and move forward.
Hey, half orc, by the way. You know, I contain
off your blood.
I contain multitudes, is what I'm saying. So
understood.
You know.
You're very, you know, multifaceted.
Thanks. I feel seen.
You're welcome.
What's this about a guy getting his ass kicked?
60 yards over. I just, like, just to, I don't know, be on the lookout. Maybe there's more of them that are getting their ass kicked, or maybe it's a gang.
Off the beaten path? Like, is it off, like, in the woods?
Yeah, or? It's, as you kind of peer off to the right side of the path, it looks like the forest gets thicker and thicker. You can almost smell, like, the overgrown moss is thick with water, and it's soaked right past the path. Almost like you're kind of entering swampland.
I'm just gonna throw something out there real fast.
Okay.
Maybe if we don't deal with the ass kickers, we could be walking along and all of a sudden the ass kickers come and try to kick our ass. Should we just go?
Do we know anything about? Let me rephrase that. Do I know anything about orcs up here? Like, what are the orcs up here do? Yeah. Okay. Like, are they cool? Are they cousins? Are they pals? Are they all evil?
I also want to roll to know about ass kickers in the area.
Oh, come on!
A one?
Hey! What's up?
Hey! Cheers.
I know, I'm just like choosing nobody.
No, you got
nobody even tries.
That's, yeah.
Okay.
Twice running. This dice is going straight down.
So you think all orcs up north are friendly? But just dumb as fuck.
Okay.
And that's all. That's literally all you've ever heard about them. It's a really isolated community.
I don't make it up much here to see the family. So
I want to roll to know about potential ass kickers in the area. What am I rolling?
History, I guess. Fuck it.
That's a 30.
Okay, yeah.
Okay. Oh, I rolled to one twice in a row. Look at 30 over here.
You know,
maybe you win some.
Yeah, you know, based on some of the interactions that you've had previously with creatures just over the last day or two, that the entire northern part of Astine seems to be populated, and two, with some of the creatures that you've just seen off to the side of the road as you're traveling over the catacombs, it seems like it's populated exclusively with a shitload of zombies, corpse flowers, and bone devils.
God damn it, we should probably take care of this shit. You know, because now that I think about it, we need to take every opportunity to reduce the corpse flower number in the area when we have something that we have to do, but we can't just fucking do the thing! We're cut! Where's my wine?!
You know what's crazy is that you started out as a pine tree and now you're a school bus.
Come again?
Okay, we're going now.
You find an apple.
I was just about to ask him about apples.
Yeah, starting a little itchy,
yeah,
maybe.
Yeah,
I would
yeah.
like to contest her for the apple.
Okay, you want to fight her for it?
Yeah, I was like, oh, I squirrel.
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay, strength.
This is my best step.
Oh,
I'm gonna
be my
stab.
If I win, that'd be so
funny.
I know.
Strength is
we're grappling, yeah. Okay,
that's an attribute, not an ability check.
No!
So, he doesn't get disadvantage?
No. Oh, I have disadvantage. Let's see if I can roll less.
I don't think you do, but let's just roll it anyway.
It's ability check. It'd
be worse.
Yeah. I got a 4 total.
14.
Okay, yeah. She... as you go to take the apple.
He goes and I'm just gonna boof the shoulder.
Damn.
You got boofed! What's up?
You fart a little bit.
I'm like, ooh, a shark is attacking!
Talon has the apple in her hand and you can hear her like...
Very safe.
Yeah.
Okay, so Cindy, as you kind of stomp off into the forest, you...
I'll go with her, by the way.
Okay, cool.
So, yeah, my dumbass cousin needs some help, whatever. All right, let's go. Shrink!
Do you two want to follow?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oof!
Okay. Cindy, you're kind of leading the way on this. You find that your flask full of wine gets magically fulfilled, just because I rolled for it.
And
I rolled a nat 20, so.
Cool.
That's an ability that you have.
Pretty good flask.
Always full of wine. So you get about 60 yards, and you come into this clearing. Off to the side of the path, you see there's actually two bone devils that are hovering over an orc. I'm going to make a reference. If anyone's familiar with the Koopa in Mario named Kamek, the Koopa?
Damn.
The wizard robes that
Kamek
is wearing. There's an orc dressed in wizard robes that are literally just blue with like white stars.
Hell yeah.
drawn by a 4-year-old. And he has a hat that is what you would think is a child's wizard hat. And he has a wand that you would see in maybe Harry Potter, whatever.
Dude, yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, might as well be a pencil.
The blue wizard.
Yeah. Like with a broom and shit.
Yeah.
He has a wand in one hand and a broom in the other, and he's fighting off these bone devils, sending out, you know, prestidigitation.
He's cleaning them. Okay.
This is an orc wizard.
We've established.
Awesome.
Yeah. Cindy, what would you like to do upon seeing this?
Yeah, I want to shoot some bone devils.
Okay.
How far above the orc?
They seem like they're almost toying with them at this point, like playing with their prey. So they're kind of swooping down and pinching on him with their claws, and creating lacerations in his skin in between spells that he tries to cast.
Yeah, cool. I'm like, God fucking damn it. So Cindy just takes out her staff of the magi and, you know, hopping off her horse, just like slams it onto the ground, like super like, oh my God, I'm so over this. And casts, uses a charge of it to conjure elemental.
Okay.
Let's go.
Which element?
Let's see. I call forth a dude, and I'm gonna challenge.
So you know that it's a dude?
It's just...
It's in the inclusive dudes.
Dude is like a gender...
Yeah. In that way.
That's like my favorite term of endearment is dude.
Yeah. Yeah.
We're taking it back.
Yeah, no, I like dude is anything, yeah. Mm-hmm. I support that.
Choose an area.
Drink or reading.
Oh,
so drink or reading.
So reading. Not even a rule. We're just
reading.
Are you reading?
DM
like, oh fuck! He closes the book.
Do I just get to choose?
Yeah. Yep. And I'm giving you the leverage to choose right now too, because of reasons.
Can you use your shirt pocket for something?
Cool. I'm gonna choose.
All the way.
Nope, I'm gonna choose an air elemental.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, so she slams on the thing, and then, like, these clouds, like, low-forming clouds start to form and, like, swirl around, and an air elemental comes out of the clouds.
Yes. Okay, this orc, Kamek, type creature sees that and prestigitation as it comes out. What would you like this air elemental to do?
I want it to attack the frickin' bone.
Does it have a top bun like Cindy?
It's like everything that I summon is that thing, but with a little top like Cindy. Like, I didn't have time this morning. I just had to throw a bun. I'm just a little something, okay? I'm sorry. This is the best. I had to put my face on this morning, and fuck, this is all like, what do you want from me?
Okay, so this air elemental comes out, these two bone devils swooping around this orc that's dressed like a fucking Koopa Troopa. The air elemental comes out and attacks. Would you just roll attack rolls on each of the bone devils? I'm giving you two attacks. Don't even worry about looking up a stat block for it.
I got it.
Super stressed about
already. All right, cool. So, hey. That's a cocked. First one's a 12.
Okay.
Next one is a 19. It does have a multi-attack, and it's slanties.
That all works out really well.
Cool.
So with your first attack, the one that misses, the bone devil kind of moves out of the way, hovers up above the air elemental, looking down on the air elemental, you all, as well as the orc that's dressed in wizard robes. The second attack, would you roll damage for it?
Yes. 2d8 plus 5. Okay, that's not good. Okay, 8 total damage.
Okay, the air elemental just kind of like pushes down with some air force winds, some hurricane force winds.
Some air force
winds.
I don't
know. Air force.
One.
it is bludgeoning if it matters.
Okay, and it smashes the bone devil kind of in one of its wings. You can see it go off kilter. These bone devils both sense that they're up against a bit of a sizable threat, and they don't want to. They don't seem to want to deal with it at this point, and so they go to flee. The one that you missed kind of takes off up in the air. It gets about 60 feet higher up in the air almost instantaneously. The other one, because it got hit, it takes a little bit longer to go off. And you all get a reaction to do something if you'd like.
So
to
it's kind
of
in
that
the air,
include
off?
The air elemental?
Yeah.
Yep.
So it's kind of already in the air a little bit?
Yeah, a little bit.
All right.
I just see a blanket literally flying away.
Let's get crazy. I'm going to pull out a javelin. Try to shoot that motherfucker down.
Okay, roll the hit.
I'm trying to
be free.
Is this another blanket going out the blanket?
Oh.
I'm gonna get settled up, and wherever Kamek is, I'm gonna yell, "Heads up, Cookie Crisp!"
Kamek looks at you, prestidigitation. Did you roll a 1 again?
No, but it was almost a 20, and then it hit the side, and it was a 5.
Okay.
Which only means it's 16.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, that'll hit. So roll damage on it.
9 total.
Okay. So as this javelin hurls through the air, it pierces right through one of the bone devil's ribs, so like some flesh bursts out of the back of it, and it actually causes this bone devil to drop down. As it's dropping down, and to remind everyone kind of what a bone devil looks like, not you guys at home, sorry, fuck you, it looks kind of like this. So
yeah.
it has a very long, pointy. Yeah, I don't know what the fuck.
Lean with it. It's
kind of like his front way.
I don't know why, but it's a very bony devil with a long, spiny tail with a point on it. As this bone devil drops down, its tail kind of flops down, and you can see it's over the top of this orc, and the tail of this bone devil pierces through the top of the orc's like trapezoid, and you can tell it gets some leverage down in there. And God. You can tell almost instantly this orc kind of cripples down to the ground. Says, "Oh, prestidigitation!" and tries to clean up some of the blood that's coming out of it.
Guys, I'm embarrassed for him. I didn't know we were going to meet him here. I just, you know, he's family. I don't know.
But yeah, the bone devil is now laying on the ground, fairly incapacitated, with a javelin through it, its tail lodged into this orc.
The air elemental casts whirlwind.
Okay.
Each creature within the elemental space must make a DC 13 strength saving throw.
Okay. They both fail.
Okay. It's going to take 3d8 plus 2 and is flung 20 feet away from the elemental in a random direction and knocked prone.
Oh no, the poor orc!
if the thrown target strikes an object, such as a wall or floor, the target takes... 1d6 bludgeoning damage for every 10 feet it was thrown at the target. Yeah, fucking. I'll just 3d8 plus 2.
Just roll a dice.
5, 10,
15,
12, 14.
Okay. So, both, they go 14 feet.
Sorry. No, that's
they
the damage it takes.
They both go 30 feet.
20 feet.
Okay.
In a random direction.
This bone devil laying on top of this orc, essentially at this point, with its tail impacted into its torso, and a javelin through it. They both go just kind of catapulting away from the original location in this clearing, towards the tree line, which is closer to all of you. So they kind of come in your direction. Oh, not dangerously close, but close. As this happens, you can see that the tail rips out of the orc, and some blood and viscera, and like it looks like a couple pieces of its lung and some of its
orc
cage
goop
come
a piece
out.
Of its lung.
Yeah,
we don't really care about
this.
Happens really quickly.
Kind of all up in there, didn't
and yeah. Both the bone devil and the orc smash against two separate trees. The javelin rams against one of the trees and kind of pops out the other end of the bone devil. And they both slide down to the ground. Do you two want to do anything?
Yeah, can Talon walk up to the bone devil and try and, like, slice the tail off?
Yeah, yeah. Go ahead and roll an attack.
Ooh, no. This is hard to use a main bone. I think it's a 10.
Okay.
No. It's a...
You get an advantage because it's prone.
Okay. It's a 10.
Okay. Oh, no. So you, badass Talon, go up. Let me know if that changes. But you go up, you take your sword out, and you, like,
stick it... I want to try and, like, slice it.
Okay, you go to slice it, and you just kind of miss.
Is this, like, a free action that I'm getting, or can I use all my attacks?
Yeah, I mean, you can try
just...
one more time.
Okay. Just because Talon has 4.
Yeah.
Okay, much better. 24.
Okay, so you try and chop it the first time, and it just kind of chinks off the bone, and you're like, bang. You go back through, and you're like, fuck you. And then you go through into the second one and
cool.
Chop its tail off.
And I want to, like, it's out of the orc already?
Yeah.
Okay, my plan is to pull it out and then stab the bone devil.
Okay, roll one more time.
Okay, very cocked.
That was...
Okay, 11. I don't think I'm adding the right thing because my thing's not what it looks like, but we'll just go with an 11.
I would assume it would be higher than that. That's okay.
Wait, so I think it would be an 11. Oh.
She's level 3. She does this every time.
16.
Okay. That yeah, makes a little bit more sense.
To this. Okay, yeah.
So, yeah, that'll hit. You stab it through where? The skull?
Yeah.
Okay, you stab the bone devil's tail after cutting it off through the skull of this bone devil. It sees this coming and is just like, this was supposed to take this. you crush it through, and the bone devil skull just shatters back into the forest.
I heard that.
Yeah, good job. Okay. You slaughtered that thing. The orc, however... While this is all going on, you can tell it's just, like, still trying to clean up the wound and the blood that's coming out of it as the life is obviously slipping out of it.
Yeah, you're up, my guy.
You haven't gotten to go.
All right, here's the deal.
please don't go talk to a tree or whatever.
What I
say the thing you're going to be doing.
I cast Cure Wounds on this raspberry bush.
What I saw, when I saw the crazy scary demon thing.
Okay.
Okay. But what I saw it kill was a branch that snapped in half.
Okay.
So I would like to approach the branch, which is the orc.
Yep.
And I just like approach it, and I'm like, don't worry, I've been here many times before. And I just want to go to cast mend on this twig that I thought broke. To like heal
that,
it.
That doesn't work on organic.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. And no, I want to tell it a story while I'm doing this.
Okay.
And I go to like cast mend on this broken branch. I'm like, one time I rolled a very big log over and there was, I'm like, hold on, stay still. There was a twig on the ground. And I thought, oh my god, the log had a baby.
And you cast mend, and as you cast mend on this twig, you see it come back together. You see this twig kind of mend. But then you also feel, as you put your hands on the twig to put it back together, you also feel it stop moving.
Well, it is a twig.
Yeah. I'm gonna, if it's okay, I'll take it to rush over and be like, I just check on our guy. I'd be like, Rudius, what's going on? Are you fixing him or what?
Well, he was chewing, now he's fun.
And as
I just want to be like,
Rudy, did you try to mend this here, this guy, Rudius?
You look like a giant mushroom with a top hat.
Oh my god.
And as you run over, Ken, because you were the first on the scene, this orc that is on the precipice of death looks up at you and says,
brother, my name is Greg.
Well, brother is a little... Anyway, sorry.
I was from the Gregor clan. Tell them I love them.
And then he just dies.
Fuck.
Then he bounces. Okay, that could have gone better.
Shit.
Oh, I have an idea! I'm going to actually do something properly.
It's very good, though.
I'm gonna use my cantrip, Spare the Dying.
That reanimates.
I just touch a living that's 0 points and it becomes stable.
Okay.
Is it too late?
Try it.
I guess.
Okay.
It doesn't do anything.
It's dead. It doesn't work.
Oh.
Or it's dead.
I could mend it.
We know. God. I want to inspect.
Yeah.
8.
You find a half-eaten apple. It looks like a squirrel kind of munched on it.
I would like to
light
her for it.
Okay.
I want to inspect the body to see if there's any, like, identifying...
Look, it's okay.
Like,
29.
Inventory, like, who they were, why were they there.
Sure. You, as you kind of search through its satchel, you find two, like, looks like teeth, like deer teeth, that are kind of sewn together like they were making a necklace out of deer teeth. You also find some, what you would assume would be orcish money, but you're not really sure. And you find a note that says, my name is Gregor McGregor.
Well, Ken, does this mean anything to you at all?
It's probably safety pinned to his shirt, the big idiot. Can't even remember his own name. Listen, the Gregors are dear people, but they're just dumb as a bag of hammers.
More
hammers, even.
I did.
Oh, by a long shot.
Did you hit him again?
Yeah, I'll go with my, like...
Hit me? Yeah, you don't have to.
My back paw.
Like, okay. Oof. Talon goes back. Hits Rudius in the chest.
Fucking horse
with her
kick.
Paw.
Where does Das Ostrich come from?
And with that, we're going to go on a short break. Thanks so much to everyone for watching. Make sure to click on those buttons that do things on some platforms. Don't drop your fucking cane. And we'll be back in like 14 seconds. Bye. All right, we're back. Oh my god. Oh, look at us. We're just fucking, we're playing D&D. Miranda has that on the mask.
It's feeling great. Having like a nice little pressure point action happening.
Yeah, he has some massage for your face. Yeah.
Thanks for me!
Yep, Austin's here. And we're gonna jump right back
he's
in.
He's doing stuff.
Everyone encountered an orc dressed in wizard-like robes with very little on him. Another thing that you did acquire from his corpse was a wand. Just at first glance, would you roll an arc?
I'm like right there, by the way, so yeah. I have designs on that wand.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not strong. I got a 9.
Okay, if you want to roll an arcane check, arcana check.
Mm.
Is there arcane
or arcana?
Arcana.
Arcana? Yeah.
Yeah.
I think arcana, yeah, feels right.
Yeah.
What about me?
Yeah, 19. You're incapacitated. I mean, if you want to roll with disadvantage.
I want to grab the lizard that I saw.
Okay, yeah. It's morphed from a tree to a lizard with disadvantage. With disadvantage.
Just see if you get a net one.
Okay. Yeah, you know, it looks like a lizard. You kind of go and chase it as it skitters off in the forest a little bit.
I've been, like, trying to grab all these apples, and I think there's something else in the
time. Yeah, you guys, you see what would look like a wizard staff or a wizard wand. Harry Potter.
Sure.
It looks like something Harry Potter would carry. It seems fairly powerful, but you don't really have enough time to, like, attune to it at this point. Do either one of you want to pocket it, or...?
I'm pretty wanded out, to be quite honest.
I have no interest in using it, but if it's an orc thing...
It looks pretty powerful.
You can see there's
probably sell it.
What you would attribute to it being, like, orcish runes and symbols kind of down the side of it. It's a very simple piece of...
I bet it casts prestidigitation.
I mean, he did that a lot, which didn't seem to help him out too much.
Super into it.
Also, getting knocked 8 ways a Sunday from your giant air elemental probably didn't hurt. Or help, I mean. It probably did hurt.
Yeah, it did do a good job. I look up at the air elemental, and it has, like, it has the Cindy wiggle. I was like,
you're welcome. My God, I can't deal with these kids. Hope you find your dad.
How long do air elementals last?
I don't know.
What do you summon them?
So you're going to take the wand, just to be clear.
Yes.
As
you sort of wrap it up.
None of us are good with wands.
It kind of speaks with you a little bit. You can hear it seep into your body as you begin to attune with it. And it just says, pressed. And you kind of just glean that this might be a wand of prestidigitation.
Okay.
That when attuned lets you cast prestidigitation as a reaction.
Surprise.
As many times as you want.
That's cool. Fun.
It doesn't cast like Firebolt or something.
It's a wand of precedent.
Feels like if it did, our guy Kamek would have done it.
So
he would have had a better answer than hand sanitizer, yeah. I think. I don't know.
Hand sanitizer.
Puro.
Sorry, I made your character a piece of shit. God, this is all
improv. The air elemental is going to chill with us for an hour.
Okay, cool.
What's his name?
Barrel Aramental.
We don't name our pets because our pets don't last long, Rudius.
Don't want to get committed.
That's right.
I don't speak your language very well.
Okay.
I'm Vernie.
So I'm going to take some of the orcish money.
Okay. It's like maybe what you would assume, being pretty unfamiliar with the northern orcs, it's maybe like $20 worth of orc.
I don't know what their custom is, but where I come from, to honor the dead, we take...
Speak to it.
Orcish money. That's your whole game. And you ask it if it looks good, which is, if you look good, which, by the way, is like the saddest thing I've ever heard. You waste one of your 5 questions on, do you think I'm pretty? You gotta pull it out of a dead person.
I wasted 2 on, what's up?
So are you really bad. Dead? Really? Really?
So what's going on? What's up?
And
you?
I'm gonna take the money.
Okay.
And as is customary in the Crushbone tribe, I'm going to put it in his pants.
Okay. Just like down.
Down stuff. You know how some, like the Vikings put the coin
on
their
eyes? I was kind of hoping I'd have something better at the end of that runway.
On their testicles.
Yeah, so, exactly. So that's exactly what it is.
Why did you do two, like, are you, what are you imagining you're doing that? Like
one coin each? No, you just lay them on there.
Lay them on top.
It's like how you put them on eyeballs for the ferryman.
Yeah.
So okay, this is what it, here's what it is.
Wait, put them on your leg pusher.
I'm going to put a coin on each ball, and that's to make sure that his sack goes with him to Orc Heaven.
Yeah, so... I'm gonna double chopstick that.
You got it? Because, like, here's the thing. In orcish culture, if you don't have somebody protect your boys with some coins,
you're gonna lose them.
The orcish devil cuts them off, and then he has to spend eternity without nuts. So I'm doing this guy a solid. I'm gonna put a coin on each ball.
Yeah.
And I'm not gonna look embarrassed.
You're talking in character.
You're welcome, cat.
I'm explaining to you what I'm doing here. Okay. Yeah. So you guys
that
don't know.
That
like this
crazy.
Seems weird and all, but like this is our custom.
So I'm gonna DM the shit out of this really quick. As
what a surprise!
You see this orc laying dead, lifeless on the ground. You kind of scooch his pants down a little bit, you know. When
respectfully,
you're, like, your significant other is drunk, and you're just trying to like
a few
pull their pants off.
Gentle tugs,
you know, whatever. Yeah. So get him ready for bed. You kind of tug their pants down a little bit, and you very delicately place two coins on each testicle. The forest around you grows silent as the sacred ritual commences. You can hear a whistle through the wind. Just take your fucking hat off.
Boss!
Take your wig off.
Don't be a bitch!
A single eagle soars over the top of you all. As you are almost sure that it's the spirit of this orc transcends into this eagle, as is custom with your people.
And I look up, and a single tear rolls down my cheek, and I whisper to myself, Bald Devil's not gonna get you, brother. Well, the hill's not gonna get you.
And the eagle soars off into the sunset.
Should I sing the ancestral song?
Nah, that's cool, because you don't know it, and you're also, like, tripping balls, so probably not.
That's true.
Okay, well,
all right,
I'm going,
over,
I'm
everyone.
Gonna go.
Oh,
now.
And then I light him on fire.
Okay, bye! Oh,
and then I light him on fire.
But there,
we
not
go.
Take it.
Yeah. There we go.
Yeah,
how?
How are you going to do that?
Just in the most, like, disrespectful way possible.
Okay.
Like, a cigar, just stab it out on its face, and it lights on fire.
Sure, always have a lit cigar.
Yeah.
Yeah,
okay. Yeah, it catches some of the bone devil blood that was on him is flammable at this point. It's oxidized enough. And it just kind of burns some patches of his body. And as you all kind of leave the scene and walk out of the forest... you can kind of tell that it goes out, just leaving a very partially burnt corpse in the middle of the forest. So
the last part of the thing is that you can't look back at the fire. You gotta walk. You gotta walk away like a cool guy. So I don't know any of that. And
okay.
I never will. And
cool.
That's the last thing of it.
Cool.
I just do a slow
love
walk.
That.
Yeah.
Way. As he's like half smoldering, it like it's shitty, but like,
yeah,
you can smell flash. He's just like,
yeah,
yeah.
All right.
And that's how we do. That's how it works too, I guess.
Yeah.
We got there.
We did.
We got there.
Good.
What's
I'll
next?
Sing it anyway.
Cool. We're on our way to the ship.
So do you guys all mount up?
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, I mount.
Like an orc burial or?
No, get on your horses.
Yes.
Okay, I'm going.
Okay.
Bye.
So everyone gets in their on their
we're
horses
going.
On your machine. You start down the path. It starts to get more and more dense as you travel further and further.
Air elemental goes away in an hour. If
yeah. Unfortunately, the air elemental is gone. Also, your craziness subsides
Holy
after you get.
Shit.
You know, you can tell just from your real attunement with travel and how. Good at it, you all are. That
we're good at moving. Good.
You know, you've been traveling for about an entire day past that.
Can I say something?
Yeah.
Sandy.
What? My God.
I think that I was under the influence for most of the day. You were a one-eyed cyclops man. You called yourself Jerry. Jerry the Cyclops man.
I am so far up here right now with you. And everything.
I'm just... Okay.
I liked you that way, kind of. You're less... You were, like, not stressful at all. You were, like, cool.
Thank,
you know?
Thank you. Thank you! Thank you, yeah. Rudy. Thank you!
As you realize that some of these magical effects have worn off, you take 26 psychic damage.
That's a hell of a come down.
Yeah. Would you roll for apple?
Can, okay, as he's talking to me, can he just, almost like he's been punched in the head by an imaginary figure, goes by?
You want to fight over the apple? You can totally fight.
No, I'm sober now.
Okay.
I don't care about the apples anymore.
What would I roll for that perception?
Unless it's actually a squirrel.
I
rolled a natural 17. Plus
okay. That, yeah. You find one more apple.
I take 17 damage?
26.
Ooh.
That was not the number that I said.
Was it 27?
I think it was, seven I said was 26. Involved. She said 17. You take 26 damage.
I'm rolling for apples.
How dare you.
Okay, is it 26?
It's 26.
27.
Okay.
I don't know. You find
an apple. You can also tell that you're starting to get out of like a forested area. You're kind of encroaching more on like a field of plains. It looks like a very plainy territory that you're coming up to as you get closer to the catacombs. And you're all fairly familiar with the layout of this area. It's well-traveled whenever a royal family member dies. There's a whole procession up to the royal catacombs and a whole procession back. You have gone on that procession once or twice just as royal members of the court, but it's been a long time. You know, shit changes. But you're getting out of the forest. You know apples might be a little bit scarce moving forward.
I'll chew slow.
Okay. And
lie to the rest of us, but don't lie to yourself.
What else was I gonna say? I was in the middle of something. Whatever. Here we are. Okay. So as we travel and get closer and closer to the catacombs. You kind of walk over the precipice of one of these hills as you travel through some of the plains, and you see, looking down, a massive temple built into the side of this mountain range, right? It's carved into the side of this mountain range. You can see that, and you're probably a couple miles away at this point, so it's fairly small, but, you know, just with good vision, you can see that there's a massive stone courtyard in front of the entrance to this mountainside cave, the mountainside catacombs. And there are a bunch of very well-lit torches. And, like, it looks like the torches are burning very hot and very brightly in front of the catacombs. So, what would we all like to do?
Remind me, Matt Melton, the player again. What's in the catacombs that we're going after?
So the catacombs that you are approaching are the royal catacombs where the royal family is buried upon their death. It's also like preparatory. So in any of the royal family that's alive, they kind of have tombs ready for them. So upon their death, they can be transported there, buried safely, and kind of transcend into the Fae realm.
Sweet.
And you're going there because Nista, the once queen of the fire, died in essentially a political coup because of their inaction due to the flooding and such of the continent. Also, there have been rumors that the plague may have started centered around the catacombs.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh. We're looking for something specific here, aren't we?
We're looking for Nista's body.
Nista's body.
So we have to do a ceremonial burial.
Yeah. That would be correct.
Cool. I look around for Nista's body.
You don't see it.
Okay. Well,
fuck.
Where the
shot? So they're trying to pass, allow the body to pass through to the Fae realm.
Yes.
Like that's the result of when they die, they go to the Fae realm.
Yes, they go somewhere to the Fae realm.
Sure.
Is the hope.
Yeah, that's what they believe.
Yeah.
Well, we should probably find that body. Get this shit over with.
Go grab one.
Oops-a-daisy.
also, too, I guess, just to for full historical reference, you don't know if the Fae Realm actually exists or not. No one's ever really been there.
The Fae Realm, that's a bunch of made-up nonsense. Yeah. Now the Ball Devil, he'll get you.
He'll get you.
That's hard. Real.
Oops. All right, so as you all approach the entrance to the catacombs.
Fuck yeah.
I'll do it for the friend.
Oh my gosh, it's so pretty!
Yay.
Yeah, I stole this. Go subscribe, to, go subscribe to this person's Patreon. It's on the thing.
Do it!
And you can all pass this around. If you want.
I want to look at it closer, please.
Yep. This is the entrance to the catacombs.
This is just a soda water.
Oh,
Mighty Morphin Power Rangers.
God. So you all arrive in a massive stone entry hall. Ken, you kind of squeak to a close as the grease in your wheels subsides.
Inside horses, the catacombs?
It's just
the
outside.
Entrance?
Just outside. It's the entrance.
Okay.
Your horses are all obviously exhausted after this long track. You haven't really given them much time to rest.
Can I snap Meriwether into existence and have her kind of tend to Balian?
Yeah.
Balian the Stallion. Yep, Balian.
Yeah. I'm glad I made that name.
It's very good.
Yeah, so Meriwether kind of takes it and hitches it to one of the torches that's outside the front. Gives it a pat. Ensures that it's well taken care of.
Okay. Braid the tail a little bit.
Yeah, rebraids it. Kind of combs it out. Make sure that all the knots and all the horse shit that was in it gets out of there. Re-cinches the saddle. Make sure it's ready to go in case anything bad happens.
Great. Flip Meriwether a coin.
Yeah, takes it.
Thank you.
I don't remember Meriwether at all.
It's my little pseudo dragon.
Yeah. Oh yeah. 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 Meriwether.
The name.
Yeah. Grabs it.
Thanks.
Then goes perches on your shoulder. That's its new voice.
Give the wife my best.
As we make our way into the catacomb, is there like some kind of stone door or something that we walked through?
So no. At this point, you're essentially in a very large courtyard. Imagine. A mountain range, kind of in a half circle, right? And that half circle is carved the entryway to this.
Cool.
Around that, on the outside in the open air, outside the forest, outside the plains, is just what you're facing right now. So there's torches around the outside borders of it. And obviously, it's fairly large. But that's kind of what you see as you walk up to it.
Okay. So we're not in. We're not inside. This is not.
This is not the catacombs are from what you can tell and remember inside that door that's on the other side.
Cool. All right. Well.
Yep.
Okay. There they are. At least I guess we just go ahead and
I'll take the lead.
Take care. Okay. Yeah. That's good. I want to cast protection from good and evil on Talon.
Okay.
Yep. So you do that.
Yep.
You're protected from good and evil.
What did you do to me? I feel weird.
Yeah. Well. Bad shit can't
warm.
Touch you now.
Gives you advantage on.
Yeah, it does some shit. And then the next time I have an opportunity to take an action, I also cast Detect Magic.
Okay, so I'll explain kind of what you're walking into with a little bit more detail, and then we can do a Detect Magic.
Oh,
very well done. So as you walk closer to the doors of this entryway to the catacombs, you can see the walls to the side, like to the left and the right of the door, are all filled with carvings of long forgotten, like old rooms. The torches in the royal chambers are infamous for having burned for thousands of years without waning. And in the center of this kind of entry, the precipice to the chambers, you see a large bowl. It's a large stone bowl on a pedestal. Certainly, like a couple decades ago, one of you very well could have been a guardian of this tomb. Like it's a very prominent thing within Astine. But obviously, you know, things have kind of gone to shit. So without further inspection, you can already tell that the door on the other side is locked. And then, what would we all like to do?
I want to cast Detect Magic.
Okay. Yeah, so it's definitely really magical. There's some magic guarding the entrance to the catacombs. And you can tell there's also like a large amount of magic centered on the bowl that's on the pedestal, which is, for everyone's reference, right fucking in the middle of this.
this.
Nice. Okay.
Is there anything in the bowl?
So you're going to go up and look in the bowl.
I guess. Are we all in there, or is she still leading the way?
I think we're all in here by now.
Okay. Yeah, you're all kind of in here. It's more freeform.
Yeah, I guess I'm like, what's in the bowl?
Yeah, so as you look at the bowl...
I changed accents again!
You're close. The stone bowl, it's probably about this large, on a stone pedestal in the center of that circle. You can see that there's a hole in the center of the bowl that funnels down to something.
Oh, fuck.
There's also an inscription covered in dust on the pedestal in front of the bowl that reads in Celestial, Slow un umka pet ent upa numpa. I wrote it all out. I can't.
I thought you were going to explain it to us. I was like, wait! Save the lore!
It reads something in Celestial that I can't
I don't remember.
I wrote this like a month ago. So.
Can Talon roll a history check or something, having been Nista's head of security? Can she roll a history check to see if there's anything specific that you're supposed to do to unlock the door? Or...
Certainly.
Okay.
Certainly.
Yep.
Sure is pie.
I think she's going to be an 11. I hate not having my paper.
Sorry.
No, it's okay. 8.
You know there's a trick to it.
Can I roll... This seems
there's
to be,
to it, but I don't remember.
I don't speak that.
Okay, that's the entrance to the catacombs, and this little bowl
is... This is the entrance. Bowl's right here.
Gotcha. Can I roll religion on the bowl? Because obviously it has significance. This is catacombs. It's a place of, honored dead. There's got to be something that happens in this bowl, maybe from, a religious rite or ritual aspect.
Yeah, go for it.
And I'm going to check out the... you said there were carvings and things, yeah?
Yeah.
On the wall.
Runic carvings just to the left and the right of the door.
Yes. I'm going to check those out.
Okay.
14.
Okay. You know that there is an ancient sacred ceremony that gets performed here whenever one of the royal family members dies. It's been so long since it's actually happened that it's kind of been lost a little bit to translation and to just the generations. And you don't know exactly what the ceremony entails, but there is a ceremony that needs to go. And as you approach the runes, would you roll history?
Cool.
No one speaks Celestial.
I don't.
Okay. I didn't get a 25 on history.
Okay. Cool. So reading the runes, you kind of put your hand over some of them. You're able to decipher some of them. You can tell one of the carvings essentially says the door on the floor, but you can't really make out too much more than that. But you can tell that there's a door on the floor.
I want to try to find the door on the floor.
Okay.
Really?
Easy enough. Roll investigation.
Okay.
14.
Yeah. Okay. So as you kind of look around, it takes you quite some time, you get up close to the pedestal on the back of it, so you all approach from this direction, so on the back side of the pedestal, you can kind of tell that there's some claw marks and such behind the pedestal on the ground. It looks like it's dusty and hasn't been touched in years.
I want to blow the dust off.
Okay.
She's very good with her mouth.
God damn it. Do not tell anyone.
We were married once.
No, we were not. We were not. That's not it.
It wasn't contractual, but it was emotional.
Or consensual,
it was one-sided. Very much a what? God.
She
okay.
was very drunk.
Anyway.
Oh, God.
And I was not interested.
Okay, so it's all on her.
It's a flipsy
okay.
daisy.
That's
sometimes
quite a
it's
twist.
An oopsie daisy. This was a flipsy.
That's a real flipsy.
Okay.
It was three taverns ago.
I think you're going to make her spiral.
You see, hey, Rudius, do you see how there's some claw marks on this door?
On your back?
There's going to be claw marks on your face here in a second. God damn it, Rudius!
Okay.
And it won't be for me.
Well, shall we do what we always do with
No,
the
we're not doing what we're doing any... No,
Last
that's,
time
that's not
there was a bowl involved,
that is,
that it
is
was
not
crazy!
A thing.
That was
that's
part
not
of
a
ceremony.
Thing.
Interesting.
You filled out with water? Water bong! Yes!
crazy.
What would you like to do?
I am the chaotic character.
I want to... Yeah, so when you say that there are claw marks on...
On the top of it, it looks like... So if you're looking at a square, obviously it's a trapdoor at this point. There's a square facing towards the pedestal at the back of it. On the floor.
Oh, I see what you're talking about. Okay.
Yeah, on the floor it looks like there's claw marks on the outside.
As if a trap door opened and something fell into it trying to claw its way back up.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Well, this is awkward. Maybe no one stand here until we figure out exactly what the fuck this
is. If someone has to do it, I'll do it.
What about trying to read
that's
this?
That's great. Do that.
I agree.
I have feather fall.
Yeah,
I'm kidding, I don't.
Oh, stretch.
Oh, hey! Thank
you. Oh, yes, please.
Oh, man, I can't really with this outfit, but there you go.
Oh, my God.
Talon?
What if we tried to read, this inscription? Wizard lady, don't you have comprehend languages or something?
You know, it's funny you should ask. No. Because...
Oh, my God.
You
are
too
a
funny
visit?
To me, but...
You've been a visit this whole time?
Yes.
I'm gonna look that.
Why didn't you give her the wand?
Do what?
Oh, I'm fine. I have plenty of wands. Thank
lots
you.
Lots of sticks, don't
Thank
you?
Thank you. Lots of...
Lots of options.
Oh my God. Just stay right there.
And they're crazy.
Yeah, I don't have that. It's funny.
So is that trapdoor, is it off of this thing?
Yeah, so the pedestal with the bowl is in the center here. Trapdoor is just right behind
it. Got it.
Going up to the door.
And then the thing goes up to the door. Wait, what do you mean going up to the door?
This is just the entrance of the catacombs.
Yeah.
Can I make a history check on the runes?
Yeah.
Discover more in the.
Yeah, on the runes on the wall or
yeah,
the text on the pedestal.
Which ones? What did you read? With
runes on the wall.
I guess I'll do the pedestal. Is anyone doing the pedestal?
Okay.
Is that new information?
Yeah, I mean...
What?
Well, I'm pedestaling it up.
Okay.
Yeah, get it.
So you're going to try to read the celestial on the pedestal, language that you do not speak.
Yes. What would you like me to roll?
I guess just roll a fucking...
Don't.
Roll two.
Is it a wisdom roll? Damn it.
Do a wisdom roll just in general, and then subsequently do a history roll.
Okay. Wisdom roll in general?
Yeah.
It's not my best roll. It's a 12.
Okay.
And then a history roll in general, which I think has no modifier.
No! That is my thing!
Is it really your thing? Because everything's been your
it's
thing.
It's a plus 6.
Okay, that's a thing.
I'm Italian now! Plus 6.
Don't roll like shit.
Hey! Okay, 20.
Okay.
Not natural.
Not natural. Okay. So you... as you... Rudius, kind of
Maximilian,
brush your hands across the celestial text.
Yeah.
You can't understand the words.
Yeah.
You don't know the language. You've never spoken it. You remember taking some lessons when you were 3. But also, as you flash back to those days in your youth when you were learning about the royal family and the bloodline and what it meant to be a part of Astine, in the era, you remember someone saying to you that that there was sacred text inscribed in the royal catacombs that said, "Use your head to pay me red. Inside of thee resides your key," and that just kind of comes back to you in a wash of important memory.
I think I have something.
Okay.
I think you need to use your head. You know, like. Continually bash your head into the bowl.
It says to bash your head into the bowl?
I am certain that it says that. And then, inside your head, is the key.
Okay.
So imagine your head being like, fuck it, until key.
I mean, you've already lost your mind so much, it might as well be you.
Are you still rolling on dead person shrooms? Like, legally you have to tell me.
I feel like very different than the earlier.
Alright, well, I don't know if that's encouraging or not, frankly.
I spittled.
Well.
But it's fine.
It's fine.
Let me think of my memory again. What was it that I thought?
Use your head to paint me red. Inside of thee resides your key.
Inside of thee?
Thee.
To paint it red.
Yeah, so use your head, paint it red. Inside of thee, I think, is certainly the key.
I just want to look around and see what,
You want to
okay,
see?
So, what's this stuff?
Oh, yeah.
I'm just water?
Stuff.
That's all just runic inscription on the floors around the...
But is it water, though? It looks like water.
Yeah, it's a very light coating of water surrounding the pedestal.
Okay.
Very, very shallow.
I hate to say it, but I think Maximilian might be, like, closer to right than he probably even thinks he is.
Yeah, say it with me. Maximilian.
I'm not going to say that. I'm going to walk up, so the other way, not the trap doorway, so coming at it from this side.
Mm-hmm.
And you said the bowl is like about the size of like a beach ball, maybe a bit little bigger.
Yay big.
Like okay. 7 medicine balls.
I don't have like a combat knife. I assume I have some kind of like knife.
Yeah.
An adventure kit. Say the rhyme one more time.
I really didn't mean to rhyme that. Use your head to paint me red. Inside of thee resides your key.
All right. Get ready with the band-aids, all right? I'm going to take my hat off.
It's kind of disrespectful.
Wipe my face. And take the knife. And just kind of go like that.
Okay.
And bend over and let it drip into the pedestal.
Okay, so as these drips of blood kind of drop into the bowl and filter down a very small hole in the center of it, you can, after maybe 10, 15 seconds, start to hear these drips impact with something underneath the bowl. You can tell just from using a general sense of time and space that it takes a good amount of time for one of these drips to fall down and hit. But after a really short amount of time, take 6 damage because I rolled a 6.
Yeah.
Sorry.
I got a good gash in there.
Yeah,
I don't do anything
here. Really the trap door behind the pedestal kind of starts to slide open underneath the pedestal. And it goes further than you would expect, and some of the blood that would have been dropping down there, you can see starts welling up from the bottom of the bowl. So, not much, but there's a small pool of your blood that has been stopped from dripping down that's now in the bowl, and the trapdoor is open.
Nice!
That, I'll peek my head down the door.
Yeah.
We all kind of like
holes
it.
I'll put on the mask, yeah, so I have that extra distance.
Okay.
It's totally dark.
Cool, cool. So Talon, you looking down there, you can see that the staircase descends down for quite some time into the darkness. Are you going in there at all, or are you just...
I just want to look first.
Okay. You can see it's just a black spiral staircase. I mean, it goes down for a while, and it's dark as fuck.
Okay.
But it looks like a well...
is it below the bowl?
It's just kind of right behind it.
Fair.
Yeah. But it's a really ornate staircase spiraling down into the darkness.
I think we found our entrance.
Is this the only thing that entered?
Yeah.
The only thing that...
Yeah, I look back up at the main entryway, and that's closed, yeah?
Yeah, it's still closed.
And like... okay.
So... Yeah, what do you guys say about maybe propping this door open?
Well, speaking of props, I noticed that nobody gave me credit for the clue.
I heard Ken give you lots of credit for the clue.
He cut his forehead.
He cut his
Did
forehead.
Did you, though? I'm like, oh, shit.
I mean, yeah, like, I got a sort of a mask here at this point. Yeah.
Holy flaking tiger.
Quite a sight to behold, I'm sure. You got, like, a napkin or something? Maybe some bandages?
Use my Kaisenscheiter.
I don't know what that is, but that's the last thing.
It's a Kaisenscheiter.
I will never wipe that on my face.
You have 2 Kaisenscheiters.
You can use my spare Kaisenscheiter.
If
that was the last thing on planet Earth to save my life, I would not wipe it on my face.
I've only used this once.
What does it look like?
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, you've used it once. Then after you say what it is, you have to tell me what you used it for and where it went. You have to. Legally, you have to.
It is when you feel the kaizing that you need to shizing.
Yep, nope. Absolutely not going into to my open wound on my head.
But it's dust clean.
It's a flesh tube.
No.
This is where the flesh tube came.
I don't care how many times you press and digitated it. It's not going anywhere near my face.
I lick my thumb.
Never.
And prestidigitation as I wipe his forehead.
Yeah, you clean it up of blood. It's still like an open wound, but the blood is for a little bit.
Yeah, can you take care of this?
I have guys. Wounds.
I just need you to heal him a little bit.
Das hurt.
Just that.
I don't care what you've done with it after you used it.
Don't put your Kaiser Kaiser away.
I know.
It's away.
I know where it's
God.
Been.
God. Let me heal it. I use lay on arms.
I really wish you hadn't licked your hand first. But I guess it's better than in the Kaiser Scheisser or whatever. So good. Scheisse. All right. Whatever.
Yeah. Shit.
There's literally no chance it hasn't been up your butt, so I'll take the licked hand.
You took damage from that, yeah.
I did, yeah, and I took a little bit here and there, too, so I'm a little banged up.
Okay, now that I am sober, I now understand that he's not a twig.
Good.
Because orcs look like twigs when you're high.
Apparently, yeah, that other guy.
Can Talon roll for apples and see if there's one that's left as, like, an honorary, like, offering
to the dead?
Yeah,
like an old decayed one,
yeah.
Now we're just like going through the ashtrays for cigarette butts is what we're doing here. Hey!
Yeah! Sure. So with your really good vision down into the cheers.
Oh yeah, so
the 20 down into the
thank you.
Darkness of the staircase. You can see that there were like ceremonial offerings left at the bottom of
the staircase. You said 13?
Okay. I'm gonna make my way down.
Making my way back down.
Down the stairs, spiral staircase.
It's really
dark.
Fucking dark and creepy.
Listen, if you guys need anything from me, just holler up. I'll stay up here and keep watch.
Do you need a Wagner?
No. No, I do not. Thank you.
Yeah.
Last time, you're not going to be my partner, Rudius. It's not. We're not partnering.
You can't wait to
go down there.
The
you're
going
to need to heal these little...
Bite?
God.
You came on to me.
No, I didn't. No, I didn't.
I was like, I don't want this, and you were like, yes, you do.
You had puppets at the time.
But
you were putting
were
on a puppet show. Yes.
You were into it.
No, I was not.
They were like, hey, and you were like,
that is not.
Listen, we got bigger stuff to deal with, but also, I think, Cindy, you need to learn a little bit about consent.
Seriously?
What the hell?
Sounds like, I know we got, this is not the going concern, but
Just go down there.
Should I go first?
You just hear Talon at the gate. I'm like, fuck yes, apples.
Talon, as they're having this conversation, you enter down the stairwell. As your head kind of passes the very top of the trapdoor, all of the clamor of their argument ceases. You look up, you can see that they're still arguing. But you're unable to hear anything that's coming out of your mouth. As you continue down the stairwell,
silence.
It is quiet. I mean, there's not a sound. As you reach the base of the stairwell, there's like a really nice offering. It's obviously decayed, but since it was in an enclosed area, not too much oxygen has gotten to it. Like it's still relatively intact, and you find five apples that are kind of gross, but not so gross that you wouldn't eat them.
Right. Put them in the bag.
Yeah. Then at the base of this area, it's a very small chamber. It's made of stone, as is what is above, and it has a very thin layer of water at the bottom of it, as the area above does. And then there's a pedestal right below where the pedestal is at the top of it, and you can see that some of the blood from Ken has dripped down onto a bronze key with a handle carved in the shape of an old, gnarled oak tree. There's an inscription carved into the stone of the pedestal that also reads in Celestial, something that you're unable to make out. So
okay. I'll eat my apple and give them like 30 seconds to come down, and then if they don't come down, then I'll go for the key.
Okay.
So we can do it all together.
They argued for far too long.
Okay.
That tracks. I don't think you had to roll for that. That seems like it went.
Talon will grab the key.
Covered in blood. Blood covered key.
It does have a lot of blood on it.
Will wait and not grab the key.
Well, I mean,
you grab the key.
I'm not involved.
As you get close to the key, you can tell nothing is necessarily wrong. It is magical, but it seems like this is meant.
Cool. She'll grab it, she'll kind of throw it up, catch it, and take a bite of her
some
apple.
Blood gets all over your hand. That was a gross thing to do. And as it spins in the air, some of Ken's blood kind of gets on your
hand. It's so high on this apple, I didn't think about this.
Why'd you do
that?
I have to.
But you do have the key.
Cindy, prestidigitate me. Blech. Okay.
So as you come back up, you come up right in time for me to hear me tell the Rudius, like, all right, look, I don't know what's going on in that brain of yours, but like...
Yeah, you look at me like...
Yeah, so anyway, it's unsettling. But anyway, I was like, it was a good idea you had, and thanks for fixing up my face and like whatever, so.
Yeah, you look fine.
I'm organizing things at the place.
Okay. There's not much there.
I found shit that's out of place.
But yeah,
and cleaning
you're
it
kind
up.
Of sweeping a little bit and making sure it's safe.
Okay. Just leaving everything a mess. This is a ceremonious fucking sign.
And so Talon, you're unable to hear this, but as you kind of get up out of that door, Cindy's frustration, Ken's disinterest, and Rudius's obnoxiousness kind of become even more apparent to you than they were before, as the realness of life rushes back into you. You have this key. You step out of this this area, and you see the pedestal still welled with blood. You see the door, kind of in front of you, I suppose, at this point. You're facing the door. What do you want to do?
I'll whistle to the group. I think I got what we needed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh my God, your face! And I go over and I press the digitation her face.
Thank you. Don't put your sticky hands on me. Just do it
clean
from the distance.
Clean as fuck.
Okay. Should we go into the door? I think this is for the door.
The key?
I think.
Gross.
Yeah. Press the digitation the key.
Yeah.
Okay. You want to clean the key of blood?
Yeah.
Maybe don't do that. DM was not into it.
Yeah. So you.
Yes, hams.
Hams.
Hey, I found a hands over in the corner. You guys were doing what you were doing.
He has a 24 rack of hands. Who does that?
It's so pretty great.
You clean the key of blood, Cindy. Yeah. And
Cindy.
The trap door that was open as a result of the blood dripping down there snaps shut.
Okay. Oh, that's interesting.
Wait, say that again?
The trap door that you went down to go get the key snapped shut as soon as the key
she was out of the trap door. She was fully submerged.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
No, I'm above ground now.
Yeah, she's
I'm
back.
I'm not underground anymore.
Oh, so it didn't close behind you.
Not
right, right, right. It closed behind
the exact opposite.
Sorry, I misunderstood. Yeah.
I didn't say that well.
It's okay.
Yeah.
Well, shit, does this...
Well, there's one way to find out.
I'll go and try and unlock the door.
As you put it in there and turn it, it obviously works. Like the key fits within the door, and you're all the way up at this door. But it obviously fits. You turn it, nothing happens. Not even a sound is made. It's silent.
But the key turns though.
Yeah.
All right, I'll do it.
Cut your head open. I'll feel it afterward.
No, you're not going to do shit. I will carry these wounds with me until I die.
You already do.
I do. Let's be honest. And then I like raise up my bangs and cut myself with.
Ken, I'm just clarifying. There's still blood in it from Ken.
In the
still
fucking
like a
bowl?
Well of blood in the bowl. Yeah,
I'm gonna go. Yeah.
No, do it.
Let's dip it in the bowl.
I was gonna say something and let you continue on, but yeah, maybe the bowl.
I almost, as the DM, didn't say.
Just wanted to see
if I was. Let's cut yourself. You go and dip it in the bowl.
Do you want to take the key from Talon and go dip it in the bowl?
Take it.
Oh, okay.
Don't put it on.
Yeah, and I go do that. And I
okay. Okay, as you dip the key back in the bowl, the trapdoor snaps back open.
Okay, this is gross. And then I go and I put the key in the hole with the blood on it and turn it.
Okay, now I'm going to get really specific.
Okay.
Cindy, you are by the door.
Yep.
I'll be right behind.
Talon is right behind you. Ken? I'm
probably somewhere on that half circle platform.
Like in here?
Yeah, yeah.
And then Rudius, where are you?
I think I'm similar to.
Just kind of in here? Okay. So as you put this key in here, or in the lock, and twist it, you can hear a series of obvious gears twisting and machinations kind of unlocking, and a couple of pss of steam, because this is a steampunk world.
Yes.
And these
we're just
massive,
a couple of steampunk girls in a steampunk world.
These massive latches at the top of the doors kind of click down from the stone wall above it, and you can tell that it is partially open at this point. Would everyone roll a perception check?
Ooh, my roll.
Fuck.
Okay, that was not good.
I'm kidding. I got a 22.
Okay.
No roll is my roll.
Okay.
11.
26.
Okay. Nice.
I got a 10 naturally, but it turns out that I got a 22.
Now okay, 10. Cool.
Apparently it's what I cared about.
Yeah.
So, Ken, as the... One of the ones that's closest to the pedestal at this point, you hear a behind you. And as you turn around to the pedestal, you see a copy of yourself, oddly enough, but much more ethereal, floating out of the center of this pedestal, almost like squeezing itself out of the blood in the bottom of this bowl. It floats above this pedestal for a moment, and then drops to the floor in front of the pedestal, facing towards the door, facing towards all of you, and lands on its knee almost in a bit of a pose. And then I need everyone to roll initiative.
Woo!
Hell.
We fighting nigga me.
Well, that's cocked.
Did I get advantage on initiative?
I have a plus zero.
I got a 6.
Okay.
I got a 15.
Okay.
You got a 6?
Yeah,
what's
I got
your initiative mod?
Plus 1.
Word.
I'm not a very
so
dexterous.
16.
Okay.
Fucking asshole. Should it be my 1?
Sorry, I feel like I have something on my initiative 2. I'm not sure.
Oh yeah, what are our skills?
You're a barbarian, yeah?
Yeah, I thought they're
right. Don't you have a, I think a...
At level
advantage
20,
on initiative,
you might get an advantage,
it's
yeah.
Feral instinct, yeah. Let's get it better than a 9.
So we're taking the 9?
We're going to take the 9.
Wow, I'm second fastest.
And that's going to be a 12.
Okay.
With a plus 0.
So with that, we are going to go to our second break.
Bye.
Bye.
God, I almost burped, and then I didn't. Fuck.
You should have.
Yeah, I didn't.
All the time.
It's not gonna happen.
There it
right.
is.
Hi.
Here's our guy.
We're the Bottlecap Brigade. Not really. This is a one-shot that's on the Bottlecap Brigade's channel.
Provisional member only.
With Matt. Matt has a cool podcast about baseball.
Thanks.
It'll be linked. Yeah.
It won't be.
So coming off break, quick synopsis. Just for everyone at home.
Sipisinus.
That's how it's pronounced.
There's, we're, nope, not that. We are, in the entrance of the catacombs of the royal family of Astine, Ken was so kind as to sacrifice some of his blood to put it into a bowl to drip it onto a key that Cindy almost cleaned and added her blood to, but decided wisely to not. And an almost exact ethereal copy of Ken has effervesced from this bowl. Just with a very quick glance, you can see that the blood that was in that bowl of yours has dissipated and essentially fueled this creature that is in front of you that looks exactly like you.
Oh, yeah.
We've all rolled initiative, and Talon, it is your turn to go first here.
So, say that again, so sorry.
It is your turn to go first. You're faced with, to give you the scene, Talon, you and Cindy are at the top of this door right here. Rudius and Ken are down here somewhere. And then there is a copy of Ken born from blood that has come out of the bowl that is right around where the trapdoor area was. So. Do we have our miniatures?
Hell yeah, I got my miniature.
I'm just going to use them for slight relativism.
But my Joe Lee mini comes in this week.
Yeah, that's great.
I can't wait.
Did you hear a
blown out as fuck.
Yes,
blown
and
out
I got it painted!
But he really
that's what the copy looks like. That's what the ethereal copy looks like.
Yeah,
just like
that's the
mega
me right
okay,
there.
Yeah. Okay. So this is the bad guy.
Okay.
This is you.
He's not gonna move much.
This is you. And this is certainly me.
So now I feel inadequate.
Oh, I remember this guy.
This is just the largest. Okay. This isn't going to be a great viewer experience.
I grabbed the biggest minis I had.
Like scary
thanks, Austin. Okay.
What's this guy?
He's.
That's the lean with it, bone devil.
Lean with it, rock.
So, okay, we're not going to switch back.
Do you
want to
just use the actual, just like, even though this isn't.
Cut the paper.
Yeah, sure.
Who needs the paper? Oh, look at you, little guy.
I know! What the hell? I'm like the biggest dude. You pick like fucking monsters over here. Yeah. What's all this?
We could also use this battle map, the one where we can draw on. Oh, well, there's little flying chickens.
My flying chickens.
Those are pretty good chickens.
So, here's Cindy.
Oh.
Here is,
you were
Rudius.
So excited
I could have gotten
the
oh, that mini is amazing. Look at that guy.
And here is,
it's to him, Mario.
Oh, it is. Ken's up there, and here's Talon.
Okay.
Is this bad dope. Guy?
That's, Super this Ken. Is, fake Ken.
Nigga Ken.
Somehow larger than you. He's Mega Bowser.
Yeah.
Which just to be clear.
Am I?
You're the side. Yeah, that's absolutely
have,
you.
Cindy. Talon,
it's the best
Ken,
mini I've ever seen.
Rudius and fake Ken. All right, and so Talon, it is your turn.
Is nothing ever so simple? And she'll run, pull out her daggers, clap them into her, both of her hands.
15, 20, 25, 30.
I think it can go like 40 feet.
35, 40.
Let's see. Ooh, maybe I can't reach it.
And I think that's a relatively realistic sense of how far you were
okay,
probably
okay.
40 or 50 feet away from it.
Did my movement, bonus action, so I can't reach it. Okay. Well, I'll, can I get in like a defensive stance and hold my action until it gets within 5 feet of me so I can do my attacks?
Yeah, you can hold an attack.
Okay. One attack, or could I hold?
You can hold your attack action.
Perfect. Okay.
Yep.
Cool. If that's what I'll do. So I'll be in a defensive stance.
Okay. Cool. It sees you run up to it.
Mm-hmm.
It's not stupid. It is Ken, reimagined. Okay. Cool. It
also
is its
make
turn.
Machines?
Ken stands up from his pose, kind of on the ground. You can see blood just kind of dripping off of it, almost seeping out of the pores of this ethereal being. As it closes into you, Talon, you will be able to take your attack.
Okay, perfect. I'm going to go for, like, the front shin of the left foot, okay. Just with both my daggers, and just kind of try to cut up the shin.
Okay,
carve them up.
Cool, cool, cool.
And
let
I have
me make sure.
Green flame blade on. Let me figure out how much it is. Okay, so let me roll to hit it.
Okay. As this is happening, you can hear it. Kind of from its belly, start to make this guttural scream. You hear just this noise almost emanate from its mouth, but it seems to stop at its mouth. But as the scream would exhale, just spurts of blood come out and hit you in the face as it goes into an obvious rage.
Okay.
Ooh, cool.
So my first two hits was a 25 and a 15.
Okay, that'll hit.
Okay.
Well, the first one will hit.
First one will hit. Okay, the third one definitely doesn't hit. Oops, shit, I just broke a computer.
Very good.
25 to hit for
okay.
My fourth one. Yep. Okay. Cool. So I'm gonna roll all these d6. Shit. 30 points of damage.
Okay, cool. So as you swing your blades,
they shine
a couple
green.
Times. Yeah, they sparkle green as you slice into the calves of what looks to be a bloody, gross cat.
Okay.
It's now its full turn, and it decides to respond back with a hammer that almost exactly resembles what Ken has.
Is this your brother?
It pulls it up to swing down on you in very Ken fashion, recklessly so.
Okay.
And swings it. Wow. 27 to hit.
Yeah.
Gee, Manee.
I'm going to assume that it's been 10 minutes.
It's been over 10 minutes since we got to the place.
Yeah.
Okay. Yep. Okay, 1d8 plus 7. So that's going to be 11 points of damage.
Okay.
On the first, and then the second one certainly hits. And that'll be 12 points of damage.
Okay.
And I'm gonna make sure that that is its turn.
Have we short rested since the last? No,
yeah.
You have not decided to do that. No.
Well, but
that,
I mean, short rest because we've been traveling. We've just been like.
I'll give you a short rest. It's tough. I'll give it to you.
Okay.
But yeah, so it does a total of whatever damage
yep.
I just said.
Perfect.
And then it will move on to Rudeus. Your turn.
I was taking my short rest. Okay, it's my turn. I'm there. Big scary version's over there. I would like to cast command.
Okay.
I think I really want to do that. So,
wisdom?
Yeah, I'm gonna do it at 5th level.
Okie dokie. Rolls a 15.
Is there a wisdom saving?
Yep.
Give me a second. I don't know where anything is on this.
I just noticed a little D&D Beyond widget on the stream is for the last game. It's not for our game.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm sorry. I did a fuck up. I could change it, but I'm scared.
Work?
You just
Sam
change it
Foxy.
In Twitch.
Really people can look at our character sheets.
Copy.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
But not today.
Not today.
Okay.
Oh, I'm sorry. It's very obvious. My save DC is 19.
Okay. So, yeah,
damn.
You win. You
all
good
I do.
Save DC. Yeah, hell yeah. Get it.
Alright. Saves my little bitch.
I'm kidding. It's not undead, is it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, that's stupid.
Well, makes no, sense, it means none of it would work.
Oh. Well, good for you then.
Oh, I have to do one of these commands. Oh. I can do outside of this, you just have to say it's okay.
Okay.
Go away.
Alright. So it does it hears, so as you focus your magic, kind of at it, you almost speak telepathically towards this fake Ken and you say, "Go away." And for some reason it seems inclined to listen and understand your command. And so it decides to turn around and walk its moving speed, which is 40 feet, away from you. Talon, you get to take an attack of opportunity.
Hell yeah!
Yeah,
because
you're an insect.
Well, I'm not going to get that one. 18? If I was to hit it with my dagger.
Yeah, so you miss. Okay. On your attack of opportunity. You go to swing, it just runs away a little bit faster than you expect it to.
Oh yeah, we're level 20 though. So.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, wait, hold on, sorry. 12, 23, 22.
Yeah, so that hits. So go ahead and roll damage.
Okay. Flame blade, 8, 9, 15.
Okay.
Damage.
Cool. Yeah, so you do that damage. It kind of walks about 40 feet away from you, stumbling as it's a little bit confused.
Okay.
Moving on. It is... do you have anything else you'd like to do?
Well, actually, it says when I cast this at second level or higher, I can affect one additional creature. And I cast it at... So, what is a creature?
I mean, any living creature.
I want to also cast it on Cindy.
Yeah. Cindy, I knew that was coming!
Yeah, you can totally do that.
Oh dear. And also, oh my.
Do I have to, it does,
Cindy has to make a, you have to make a wisdom
save.
That's assuming I don't counterspell it.
Counter.
Ooh,
which you can do.
She's clapping back.
Would that counter what I did to it?
Yes. Ooh. Ooh.
Do it.
That's like so proper level.
Do it. I either do that or I make a wisdom saving. I'm going to make a wisdom saving.
Yeah. Have to be at a 19?
19.
Let's go see and do that.
That's not that tough. You probably have a bunch to that.
That's cocked as shit. 24.
Okay. Cindy, so you recognize that this happened to you.
Can I still say that word?
Yeah.
Do what you did to me last summer to it.
It's a hell of a command.
Cool.
So this all happened. You blocked it out in your lizard brain. And you just said absolutely not.
Oh no, I
mean just like absolutely you can't command me to do that. But
I'm gonna
light
it on fire, yes.
I'm gonna, but not cause you said
tube of lube. That's not what I did.
Would you like to do anything else for you?
Oh, tube of lube.
I'm so bad.
Okay.
Yeah.
Kenneth.
I played a tube of lube.
I'm gonna turn a look at it. I'm gonna see it's basically like, is it, I mean, we have a big guy on it. Is it literally bigger than me, or is
no,
it the same exact
the
dimension
exact
as me?
Same
okay.
As you.
Yeah.
I'm going to look at it.
I don't know. I'd say he's a little bit bigger.
That
okay. Hurt. That hurt you.
And I'm going to look at him, and especially when I look at him like walk away, I'm going to take some of the blood from my head and like smear it across my face.
Yeah, let's go.
And I'm going to pull out my hammer and I'm going to say, "You and push, and really go into a rage as I slam my hammer
like
onto
Super
the
Saiyan.
Ground. Yeah, like a big, like a Soul Calibur, like heavy attack, like
yeah,
boom.
Heavy swing.
And then, and then I rage. And
follow it with like the fat little thing.
Yeah, you know.
Yeah.
And go after him. tear shit up.
Hell yeah. Yeah.
You're pretty far away from him.
I'm a pretty speedy boy.
He moved 40 feet. He is as well. He moved his
I
full...
I did push him away.
Whatever you are.
I made him go.
He would he be, is. Wouldn't he?
And yeah. I made Cindy remember that night last summer. Nope.
So you can get within 10 feet of him.
Okay.
I'm sorry to do that to you.
That's fine. No, that makes sense. Because I can move 40 feet as well.
Yeah.
So if that's... So we're about like this,
yeah,
you'd say?
Yep.
Yeah, that seems fair.
Throw it.
No, it's not like a hammer. It's not like a Mjolnir situation. That'd be pretty dope if it was, TBH, but... Boy, I really want to hit him with my big stick that I have.
Oof, let me think. Can I help you? If you throw it, can I bring it back to you somehow? Range is... Oh, dude, I can give you a spiritual weapon. You throw it, I give you a new one.
No, that one's pretty good. I mean, no offense to your spiritual weapon, but that one's pretty good.
I was really excited about that.
You know what? I'm going to have the Warhammer in one hand as I'm running. I'm going to whip out another javelin with my other hand.
Ooh.
And as I'm running at him, just heave and hit him with a javelin.
Okay, cool. Roll it ahead.
The old action word.
You know, heave. Ooh, the lolly. Yeah. He's gonna get ouchie. 23?
Okay, that hits you.
It does hit
me. It's
your
character sheet.
That's interesting.
So I get +4 melee damage. This is not...
It's
doesn't
not a
count.
Melee attack.
So it's a ranged attack. So it's just gonna be regular times. But I do want to do an ouchie on him. And this is the only way. So we go and get him. 4, 8.
Okay.
I'm getting for 8.
So as you fling this javelin at this creature that's a copy of you, it impacts into it, and you can see the blood starts to seep and kind of corrode the javelin. As it starts to tear the javelin apart, you can tell that because you threw it, it seemed to have a bit more of an effect on it.
Okay.
It seems to sink a little bit deeper. And you said 8?
8 damage, yes.
I can do math. Alright, there we go. What else?
I do get 2 attacks. I do have another javelin. This doesn't have to make it do anything special. But I want to use this fire with this rage. So I throw the first one, and as I'm like coming back, I'm gonna pick up the second one, put it in the air, and smash it with
yes!
my like
okay.
dart it into it. But that doesn't have to do any more damage,
yeah, well,
doesn't have to do anything cool,
let's
except that I'm just gonna
do
it.
Athletics to see, you're welcome. Let's roll in athletics to see how well this goes.
You probably get advantage on that, no?
I mean, he doesn't need it, let's be
That's
honest.
A 35.
Yeah. So, yeah, you throw this up and you take it like all the cool coaches do in baseball, and you pass it up flat, aimed straight at the U, and you, as you swing, you hit it right on the end of it, launching it just directly at this creature. So roll attack with advantage.
Yeah!
And then add an extra 1d6 to the damage.
Hey, thanks.
Cool.
I was doing that purely for the stream, but I appreciate the extra juice
on
it.
Do it for the stream.
I mean,
do it for the
I said athletics before I thought about plus 7 to the damage. With advantage.
Yes. Yeah, like 27.
Okay, yeah, that hits you.
Okay, it does hit me. Use an extra d6, so it'll be 2d6 plus 5.
Yep.
7, 12.
Okay, cool. I can do math again. All right. So as that second javelin impacts, it actually hits right next to the first one. And digging deeply, you can tell that the blood of it starts to really corrode that javelin as well. But you can tell that it knocked the copy of you back a step. Really, really did some damage there.
Yeah.
Marco Bro. Cindy.
Yeah. Cool. So Cindy is like, God damn it! Fuck it! You know, I feel bad about this, Ken, because to be honest, you're my favorite.
followed closely by, you know, to be honest, I just don't like Rudeus. And so
she
Cindy,
said she doesn't like you.
Cindy like puts her like staff out and her like fucking robot arm, and you see like this like arcane energy develop in the robot arm, and the staff of magi starts to light up, and she casts one of her signature spells, fly, as like all of these like steampunk pieces of metal start to arcane attach to her body.
Okay.
And it, like, develops, like, Iron Man wings.
Yes!
Let's go.
And then,
Bring it on back.
Now she flies. And, I'm going to fly 60 feet into the air.
Okay. You are very, very ascended. There is steam jutting out of all of the parts of your newly mechanized wings, as you overlook the battlefield.
Dope as hell.
And I think that's all that I can do.
Okay.
I'm gonna have bonus actions.
Cool. How long does that last?
10 minutes.
Okay. Cool. So next up, Talon.
Okay. I'm just gonna run up, try and chase it.
You get there.
Okay.
You get there. There you go.
Is it wearing a loincloth like that?
What are you wearing?
Oh yeah, I was in the clothes.
So that begs an interesting question. Do I Hulk out of what I am wearing when I rage or not?
We're asking the tough ones right now.
I'm going to say I don't.
Okay.
I'm going to say, because we have this established, what happens when I rage is I turn into like almost like Dr. Manhattan, like green,
okay.
But it's
okay.
A green kind of like
okay.
Glow, not
that's
a blue.
That's right. I remember that. Okay.
Yeah. And kind of all like forms and pieces. Like I'm not naked. There's just no.
Yeah, I was going to ask his dick.
No. No dick, no balls, no nothing.
No balls.
No. Nothing. No parts whatsoever.
Yeah. Right. So it's not really Dr. Manhattan.
Not really. Yeah, because there's a.
It's very
sometimes,
sort of a,
but only yeah. Sometimes, not all the time. All
right. In my head, Ken loses his gender when he rages. He
love
becomes
that.
Sort of
love
like
that.
non-binary, exactly.
Yeah. Precisely. Okay.
Only in the
when he's angry
in the rage.
And
yeah.
Then he's
yeah.
Copy again.
So he's just sort of so that's sort of what. But ordinarily, so if he would be look, he would look the same. So he's
okay.
Not really wearing anything.
Copy. Okay. Sweet. Talon's just gonna run up and just gonna try and go for like two. She'll have her talons.
This was all just an aside. The flavor of this attack. Goddamn.
It's related.
It was, but now there's no balls. So Achilles and
so
then
I'm sorry
Achilles.
To take that from you.
That's
I really
okay.
I wrote
that,
that in the
okay.
Very beginning.
If the dick was there, we'd change things.
You'd send
was,
him to ball hell.
I was gonna
apparently.
Precisely. I heard your ritual.
Yeah, that's dope.
I thought you might like it if I cut off the balls. I'm trying. To be nicer and open with
you
fucking
call it a nip.
People. And then she's gonna do two attacks on the right Achilles and two attacks on the left.
Swing
it out. Did you see
wow,
that roll?
That's cool. That's
it
cool.
Was a shitty roll, but that landed
it's
on top.
It's pretty cool though. Keep it.
17.
Okay.
No. 27.
Yes.
That's my lucky number. Natural 20!
I'm gonna get a drink.
Wash your hands.
23.
One missed.
Okay, so three hit.
Use prestidigitation.
And I think I'm. Yeah. Hold on. While we're getting drinks, I look up a rule. I'm looking up a rule.
Drink.
Drink again.
I'm not.
Someone
want to
throw a hydrate in there? Let's just keep it going.
I'm not looking at the appropriate, like, rare item thing that I shared with you. I'm looking at the spell's flame blade,
so
but I'm realizing that's not what I have. I think I messaged it to you.
Take your time. While you're looking this up,
so sorry.
I would like to let everyone that's watching us right now know that I love you.
Talk to
me. I hope you're great. And I hope you have a great weekend. And also, if you like this stream and if you like the concept of this one shot, let me know in the chat because I'm thinking about doing a little bit of touch up on it. I'm thinking about doing a little bit of working over and tossing it on the good old Patreon as a content.
Ooh.
Speaking of a little touch up and a little Patreon.
Hydrate.
We are woo! Touching up our Patreon over the course of the next couple of weeks.
Yes.
Our new Patreon will launch August 1st.
Mm-hmm.
It's going down.
Austin, how fucking crazy is this new Patreon going to be, Tim?
so fucking crazy. Oh. Like, if crazy, it, from on a scale of like meh to
fuck damn,
yeah,
it's gonna go
fuck damn.
That's great.
On the Patreon.
That means that's 5 out of 10.
Yeah. And also, we have special gifts for all of our loyal patrons that have been patronizing up until this
point. And I'm going to go so hard. I'm going to go so hard on this as
to... Oh, fuck, I lost count. No, I didn't. Hold on, 54. Okay.
I'm going to send out my original notes and character sheets for, like, the first one that fucking... I don't know. I'm going to figure it out. Grace, if you want this...
That's for free.
But, like, I'll figure it out.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go hard with releasing this. I'm also gonna release it as a PDF, and I'm gonna put it on Reddit or something. I don't know. I want to give it to people for free as well, but we'll see.
Unless I royally fuck this up, 90 points of damage.
Wow. Holy okay.
Because I rolled really good on the critical, so
yeah.
I got a double.
Yeah, that's, I mean, that is an acceptable
weirdly, we started
okay,
getting
okay.
At the same time.
I didn't even
we
add
the same name,
any,
but we don't get along, okay? We don't
fucking,
get each other.
Like... any of my decks.
So you're what? It
would be,
am I right?
It would be per hit, so it would be 4 times
God
damn
it.
Right?
Yeah, so 105.
Wow.
Okay.
Just why?
So this is more of what I was expecting out of this party.
Okay, great.
How would you like to do this?
Yay! Okay, I'm gonna, like, take my two daggers, fuck the Achilles. I'll do, like, one with the Achilles, and then it's like, ugh, it's boring. And I'm gonna slam both my daggers into the back of its thighs, and then for my natural 20, I'm gonna pull them both out at the same time, like a ninja warrior style, and try and hook into the top of the shoulder blades, pull myself up, and then just do a classic, like, neck swipe.
Yeah, and as you do this, can you see the copy of yourself just getting fucking massacred at this point?
It looks exactly like him.
Yeah, Talon, at this point you are able to climb up, and he's facing away from you all at this point. You climb up his back like a goddamn fucking ninja, slit his throat, and ride him to the ground as he slowly gasps out the last bits of blood that was fueling him from
what
this
pedestal.
Say?
That's some kind of worship.
He can't really speak. He just gasps.
Can I roll for it?
To hear what he speaks, he doesn't say anything. He just gasps.
Gurgle.
You don't need
to. I was kidding.
But it won't
yeah.
speak.
And as you ride him to the ground, and he sinks to like a really prone neutral position, he starts to dissipate into blood. Roll a Constitution saving throw.
Oh, which I get
dice?
To add a thing to really quick. That I didn't know about. Okay, it was my proficiency and then half, so 9, 16, 25.
That's pretty good.
Okay. Also, you just roll a con saving throw. So, as he kind of lies prone, he dissipates into blood. You're covered in a fair amount of blood at this point because...
dude.
He's mostly a blood ethereal creature. You don't suffer any negative effects, but it's pretty gross.
Cindy,
I'm like flying 60 feet. It's like, I'm like, it's already fucking over. Oh, I guess I'll just go fuck myself then, and I fly
well,
down.
Well, before you do that, could you at least just get
yes.
the shit off of me?
Yes, I and I fly down.
That's a 10.
Okay. By digitation. In fighting and seeing your a copy of you, you're a little bit unsettled as a result of it.
I'm pissed.
I think someone's hydrated, by the way. I don't know. If
yep.
We got that one.
Got
unless somebody
got
to do it again. I don't mind doing it again, though.
I,
yeah.
know, fucking, I think maybe.
This one's free. The rest of them?
This is a freebie.
So as a result of that, seeing your own body die, seeing him perform, honestly, fairly poorly in battle more than anything, sets you off. You start to get a little bit self-conscious and paranoid of your own performance and if you could have fought better in that battle and if you could be a better you. For the next 3 hours, suffer disadvantage on wisdom and charisma checks.
All right.
We have to drink twice.
We have a double hydrate.
Thanks,
Thoth.
Thoth.
Thanks, Thoth, freezing all your things finally.
All right, but it is now dead on the ground. So the doors of the entry to the chamber swing open very slowly.
It's just blood on the ground.
What?
It's just
blood. It is now just blood.
All of his clothes, his loincloth.
It's all just blood.
I have my steampunk like wings on, so I'm like, sorry, I'm gonna fucking keep these on.
You're still flying. Yeah. You're still
wearing. Fix your hair while you're at it.
I'm just like
a mess.
my hair is like even more. It's like, oh fuck, because I've been flying.
Yeah.
Give me a sec. Fuck. I don't have time. I just don't have time in the mornings. Okay, I'm sorry. I just
your scalp takes like 5 minutes. Don't give me this. You don't have time.
City, I think you look great.
Shut up, Rudy.
I'm also like ravaging apples.
Okay.
How
many apples do you have left?
So I'm gonna say that I eat 3, so I have 2 left.
Okay.
How many did you have?
I rolled a nat 20 on my finding.
On your apple finding roll. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Of course.
I stole a lot from offerings to the dead.
I'm gonna stay in the rage the entire 1 minute. Okay. And while I stay in the rage, I am going to be raging.
Okay, fair.
So like, I'm gonna go over to like where the blood pile is and just like smash it a couple of times with the hammer.
Yeah, fuck it up.
And just like,
yep.
Trying to like, you know, like when you are playing a Super Nintendo and you lose for the millionth time and you want to pull the controller
sometimes
in half.
Sometimes you do.
Sometimes you do, yeah. But you just hear, you need to hear that like creak. Yeah. That's me. I know I can't smash the ground, but I'm gonna try.
Yeah.
Because this blood is tainted and bad and it wasn't like, it's not even a crushed bone, and it was embarrassing, and this and that.
Yeah, you get a lot of your own blood in your mouth.
And
do a lot of damage to the ground. I mean, you fuck up some ancient stone.
Is he auditioning for the Blue Man Group? Or?
Is there... I'm going to go take a swing at the big bowl, too.
Okay, you want to hit the bowl?
Yeah.
The right. bowl?
Go ahead and just roll.
He's going to hit the bowl.
I'm like, roll your bowl, bro!
I'm going to try and push it over, and if it's like set in the ground, which I think it is, I'm just going to just smash it.
Okay.
The old baseball move?
It's a 27.
Okay, yeah. So as you make contact with the bowl, which you certainly did... Roll a strength. Just a strength.
Straight up and down strength?
Yeah.
Okay.
Straight up and down.
Oh,
I guess I'm so colorful. That's a 12, but I don't like that. So I'm going to use Indomitable Might and just turn it into a 20.
Woo!
Okay, cool. So that unfortunately fails.
That's because I don't really want to break it, but like...
A 30 or better would have...
That's fine. Yeah, so I could... it was in the range. That's fine.
I mean, it's still hard to... say. You guys, level 20, 30 is fair. You go to swing at this. Hit it. Your hammer, as it makes contact with the bowl, instantly just gets repulsed by really, really old magic that this entire pedestal is imbued with. You take 22 points of damage as that kind of shockwave emanates through your hammer and up into your arm. And you can actually see the tip of your hammer kind of chipped off a little bit, and there's a bit of a crack in it.
Okay. You said 20 damage?
21, 22?
22 it is.
22.
I think 22 is right.
I think I said 22.
If it's wrong, then we're going with it.
Okay. Yeah, but your tantrum has yet to come to a close.
I think, so it's a minute, so I'm going to smash that, that'll be kind of the piece de resistance to all of it.
Swing
again. And when I do that, and I take that force damage, and it kind of like, and then I kind of look at my hammer and see that I've chipped it, I think it just kind of come out of the rage and just like fall to my knees.
You're sad.
Okay, yeah. I would like to run to him.
Okay. You run.
Kinvoth!
What?
How art thou?
Not great. Not great.
Under most circumstances, I would then elect a person to explain to me what in this situation would a mend do to dust weapon.
I guess I don't know.
It looked like maybe you possibly caught your weapon.
Yeah, I think you're right.
I would like to break down the exact emotions that took place to make you do that.
I really feel like talking about it.
Let's talk about it.
No.
I like sit down like crisscross applesauce, man. You know what I'm saying?
No. Yeah, no.
I just sit down like, sit.
We're not going to do this.
Sit with me.
So as this conversation is happening out of the entrance of the catacombs, a really warm gust of air flows through it. It seems like they haven't been opened in years, potentially. It's hard to tell, but there's warm, dry, stale air within the catacombs. And it rushes out. So you two are having this conversation over by the pedestal. What are you two doing?
I would be... I mean, not that it matters. I would be... That's about where the pedestal is, I think.
Well, I got prestidigitated.
So I think the moment Ken started throwing his tantrum, I have seen that before, just, you know...
We've been together for years.
The cereal aisle and the candy aisle. And so I'm just like, just leave them. Just you ignore them. And then I turn and I would have gone towards the door.
Okay.
Just like hovering it with my Iron Man.
Flying around as you can.
I guess I'd like to cast Mend on his chipped hammer.
Okay. You're kind of able to see the little chipped off bit because it didn't go very far. I mean, it exploded off.
A little chippy.
Yeah. And you're able to mend it and the crack gets repaired.
Does he notice this?
Roll a perception.
I'm almost certain that I don't, but I like this because I'm gonna do a thing. It's like a 14.
Yeah, you do.
Okay.
You do notice.
Yeah.
So okay, that's fine.
Okay. Well, I just want to be like, Ken. Life is hard. There's ups and there's downs. There's lefts and there's rights. There's blacks and there's whites. In color. Not with
blue. Okay, sure. I mean, either way is fine.
Yeah, there's red and there's blues. Okay? Every sentence. Reds and there's blues. And did I say lefts and rights already?
I think you said lefts and rights. Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
So, realistically, some things are hard.
Mm-hmm.
And this is certainly something that was difficult for you. But you made it through it. And for the better.
Yeah. Yeah, this weapon's been in my family for like, you know, 1,000 generations, and I've never seen it break before. Never seen, not a chip, not a crack. It's defended the crush bloodline throughout the ages. And like a child, I broke it. Because I think justifiably, and I get a little... is upset that my blood was taken from me without my consent and turned into whatever the hell that coward thing was. And anyway, behaved like an ass. And I'm sorry. And you know what? You're a pretty good guy, Rudius. Thanks for fixing my hammer.
The
crushed bones, they owe you a debt. It's not just any hammer. You don't just fix it. So it's pretty wild that you just, like, fixed it. So
it was
like,
Kendra.
Okay, well... Seems like it would be a bigger deal. Maybe I just have never tried. I don't know.
I'm kidding. It was very, very difficult for me to cast.
Okay, I don't know that that's... You don't need to do that.
It was a cantrip.
Yeah, that's fine. You just
would you like me to make a weird racist reference again?
No. I don't have... No,
that was not the intention originally.
No,
It was just polar opposites of things.
Anyway,
unrelated to skin color.
That was, thank you. I got it out of my system. That was embarrassing.
You feel better?
Much better, thank you.
Yeah.
You know.
You look better.
The crushboat guardian that channels through me that becomes when I get upset, when I get angry. That's not what he's there for, so.
You know what, Ken? Not only do I think you've come a long way from this, you look better. You look great.
Stop.
Come on, yeah.
Yeah.
You have a great tan.
Okay, well.
It's very linear from your shoulders.
I gotta stop wearing t-shirts so much.
It's great.
You get one inspiration.
I'm not even a bard.
No.
I'm just galvanizing.
What is that the shit?
Yeah, so you can use inspiration to re-roll.
Yeah.
Or to get somebody else to re-roll. Yeah, thank you. All right, you know.
Absolutely. It's because not only am I a believer in all four of us, I'm a believer in Ken.
That's beautiful.
And orgy.
And so
and you ruined it.
As you two are in
the... Told you!
As you two are in the entrance...
She was part of the first one.
That's not true.
To the hall.
She initiated it.
And you two are back by the pedestal still. Karen, Cindy, sorry, and Alan.
I always mix that up.
Upon entering the hall, you see a very well-lit chamber. There are large stone pedestals lining a lengthy hall. We're talking probably 100 yards, maybe about a football field, down a very long hall. And at the very end, you can see two doors. And in the center of the two doors, so on the left and right, in the center of the two doors, there is a very ornate shelf with a very ornate, very large urn on it. Again, it's similar torches to what you've experienced before. You know that these have been lit for thousands of years. There are some of the similar runic symbols on the inside of this chamber as were outside. But there's no real signs of life or anything.
Okay. We'd like to check out the urn.
Are you two going up there?
We're chatting at the moment.
Okay.
Yeah,
I'd like to go up.
I'd like that very much.
you cutty.
I'll go first.
Okay.
I think someone else.
Yeah. Yeah. So,
based on what we know, I mean, would inside the urn we assume are the remains of Nista?
Well, so Talon, as you get closer and you see this urn, you see there's a sigil inscripted on it, you can see that it's been kind of the top of it hasn't been broken open, but it's been slid open. It's kind of sitting off to the side of it. Do you want to go up and investigate?
Check out the sigil, yeah.
Okay, yeah, roll an investigation check.
Natural 15 plus, so at least 18. Hold on, let's see if I have any. Yeah, 18.
Okay.
You're really good with your phone.
And so
it's harder on
there. I don't like it.
You recognize the sigil on the front of this urn as a sign of sealing. As you look into the urn, you see that there's nothing inside of it. From your roll a history check too.
Way to go, Sam.
Thank you.
Five.
Oh. It shouldn't be open.
It was less than that.
Be on your guard.
I want to cast detect magic. Yeah.
Okay.
And we're supposed to find Nista's body. It would be weird if she was already cremated.
It would be strange.
Okay.
Certainly.
Okay.
That would be very strange.
Okay. That's fair.
Detect magic. a sign of sealing is a very powerful form of magic. Almost as strong as the glue that you found that I can't remember the name of. So it's a very strong form of magic. So.
Cool. And
it has been broken.
We got a broken seal. We got a big old room with the urn in it.
Mm-hmm.
Any other?
You could also try to roll a history check to see if you know what that's all about. But a five isn't going to do it.
Yeah. I'll do that.
Okay.
Ooh. Before that happens, can I roll thaumaturgy?
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, that sounds fun.
I want to.
I have 22.
Okay. Before that result, while it's on the stack.
Oh God,
Jesus.
I want to do thaumaturgy, create like a voice, basically, for him to hear.
Okay. What does it say?
Cindy hears, hopefully.
Yeah.
Like,
do that same dirty thing you did last summer.
Okay, I'm going to fireball at firebolt at Rudeus.
Okay,
no, there's really no way
that you don't know that he's doing it. Let's be clear, you certainly know that this is him passing.
This is a common high school horror trope.
I'm gonna firebolt at his feet
and roll to hit.
I will dance.
19.
This is just my AC.
Yeah.
Probably hits. Yeah, oh, without a doubt.
Cool. So
roll damage.
What level are you casting it at, or is it just
A cantrip.
Ooh.
Does a lot of damage, though. So good cantrip.
Yeah.
Cheap.
16.
Okay. You take 16 damage, your boots light on fire, too.
I guess we are level 20. Yeah. We're all very good at what we do.
Is that what you're talking about, Rudeus?
I would like to use my reaction. Hellish Rebuke. Since we're doing it.
No one beats us us.
I take your response to being damaged by a creature within 60 feet that I can see, to assume.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
I point my finger. And the creature that damaged you is momentarily surrounded by hellish flames.
Okay.
You must make a dex saving throw. But yes,
Is this a spell?
Yes, you make a dex saving throw.
Well, this is a racial trait.
It's a racial trait.
As a tiefling.
It's a response to being hurt.
But it is also a spell that you could counterspell.
I will do that.
It is a spell.
Yeah, I'm going to count. I'll counter.
Is this how you all flirt?
But I flip you off.
Okay. I will cast.
Get
a
room,
spell.
You two.
So yeah, that use that spell slot. Certainly.
Yep. Totally did.
It's worth it.
Okay.
I'm like, ow.
Leave me alone, Rudeus. God, you're the worst. Oh. Fuck.
You're.
I got a 22 on the history.
Okay, yeah. So as that all resolves,
she's slurring.
I'm drinking wine.
You're a wonderful person. No, you are lying.
You can tell from just a lot of the lore that you've read and your knowledge of the royal family and the catacombs and what the symbolism of this all embodies that each previous royal family line, each of the descendants of the royal family are buried in their own new rebuilt set of catacombs. Outside of these catacombs is you're not exactly sure what, but you know that it is a great and ancient evil that is contained within an urn outside of the catacombs. The point of the burial chambers and the point of the catacombs after the death of each of the royal family members is to ensure that the power to contain this great and ancient evil is there and prevalent and still, you know, strong enough to contain this evil.
That rules.
That's about all you can tell from that, from looking at the urn. That's what you recall. There is more. But
okay. It's like, well, somebody set a great and ancient evil free, so we're gonna have to deal with that. That's gonna be fun.
That actually tracks. We think this is the source of the plague, right? The source of all of our troubles, basically. Maybe the reason why my kingdom's underwater right now.
Yeah.
Well, if it's so ancient and evil, where the fuck is it? Show your face. And Talon will just say that to the greater.
It echoes throughout the halls. Face, face, face.
I get it!
Do I, like with the detect magic, see any remnants of of like magic anywhere?
Just the sign of sealing that has been broken. Cool. There is still a small ebb and flow of magic from that. Looking at it, there's a door on the left and the right.
Okay. I want to look around for clues to see if anybody has physically been there and taken one of the doors in the past or has left any trace of
presence. Investigation.
Well, that's a 16.
Nope.
Okay.
You said there are two doors?
Like, yep. One on the left and one on the right.
Okay, I'm just going to go open the one on the left.
Okay,
cool.
Sounds good. So as you go up, and the urn is still on the shelf in the center of those two doors. As you go up to the left door and open it, it hasn't been opened in ages. It's been a very long time. It creaks open. As you open that door, you're the first one in, Talon. You see a room in front of you. It's not large. We're thinking about the size of, you know, whatever you would consider to be a burial chamber, large enough to fit three corpse-holding units. Caskets.
There it
Thank
is.
You. Three large three large stone caskets that face you. You open the door on the left, so there's one on the left, one on the center, one on the right. They seem all very large. The one directly in front of you, you can see it has Nista's name carved very clearly into it. Jax is the one in the middle. Yarway is the one on the right. You can see that both Jax and Yarway, the tops of the casket are open, propped open by very large stone slabs. Nista's is closed at this point.
I'm gonna walk up and try and kick the top off of Nista's.
Okay, you just kick it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Roll a strength.
Also, it's one of my favorite songs ever.
It's a very good one.
Is that cocked?
Sure.
Okay, I shook it and it definitely was cocked. Okay. Sorry, what was that roll again?
It's just a strength.
Okay. 14.
Okay. You kick it. It's a massive, probably 600-pound piece of stone on top of this casket.
Cannot do that.
It's a big piece of stone.
So the other two are hinged open?
Yeah.
Ken? Might need your strength for this.
You called?
That's not you. Literally not your name, Cerunius.
That's true. Can I kick it?
Sure, you can try.
Go for it, my dude.
Literally a 600-pound casket. If I can't kick it, I'm sorry.
Das Strength!
Sure.
I want to kick it.
Yeah,
sure. He goes over and kicks it with his, like, charred boot.
Yeah. Your feet are not in... Kick with disadvantage.
Yeah, if your burned, fucked up feet, like, manage to, like, kick
Where
this thing open... Because they're on fire.
They're on fire.
I firebolted them.
But please try it, because if you roll a crit on this and it happens, I'm gonna take a lap.
I hurt.
You countered my
spell. I will counter your shit.
You countered my counter to your spell. Okay. I'm gonna just strength roll?
Yeah.
Just strength.
Yep.
How about athletics?
Nope.
I have a modifier, but not just strength. It's a level.
Yeah, you kick it.
Wait, I do get a plus two.
You kick it. It's a very heavy block of stone.
Who taught you people how to move heavy blocks of stone? You just don't kick them. I'm going to go over and grip the side and very slowly
try to lift it.
Lift it.
Okay, you can use it in athletics.
I can get a plus three
for this.
I will say that would be the dopest thing I've ever seen if it works.
I
was rooting for you. I was rooting for you.
I would, even if you critted that. I don't know what I would have done.
Not even a crit. It would have been worth it all.
31.
Okay. Yeah. So, Ken, you go up to this massive stone. Very, very, very strongly are able to lift it up to the corner of the casket and off to the side. As it kind of slides down the edge of it, it makes a very loud, like, stone on stone.
As I'm doing this, and I'm not going to not do it, but I'm just like, why are we doing this again? Have we looked at everything else? I mean, it's cool.
Yeah, and
you just want to see if her body's in there.
Yeah, and being the first one to open this up, Ken, you pry it open, it is empty. There is a note at the top of this casket.
Wait a second.
Inside of it.
Pull it off the old fridge.
Can you read, Ken?
It's in common, and it
can you read
common?
I'm gonna stare at Rudius the entire time as I go.
Would you like to cast me a spell so you can read?
And I take my reading glasses out. Yeah, I have reading glasses. I'm a little older.
Das seems slower.
And I'm gonna read it kind of at him.
Yeah,
like I can definitely read.
It says, Just with your basic background and history and knowledge of the three world heirs to the throne, you can tell that from proclamations and such that have been issued out of Ephire that this would be Nisa's handwriting. It's very distinct. It's very like royal. It looks very well written. It says thank you with a period at the end of it.
Gang, unless I miss my guess, this is Nisa that wrote this.
What does it say?
It just says thank you.
Is it written as if like she's being sarcastic, or is it written like a genuine like thank you?
Yeah, that's my
question.
Right.
Let me see if there's any emojis that sort of give context.
There's a period.
Talon kind of lets out this big roar and just like fucking punches the wall. What the fuck is this body?
So as you punch the wall behind you, that it once again echoes through the chamber. Roll a perception.
Oof.
It echoes through the chamber.
Yeah, dude, I don't even know.
It's literally one from the worst roll possible.
Yeah, 9.
Yeah, it echoes through the chamber. That you can tell that the urn, however, on the other side, you hear that slipping a little bit closer to the edge of the platform that it's on outside of the door. Like, almost like it's teetering on the edge of falling off and breaking.
Fuck.
On the edge of glory.
Does someone want to grab that?
It's on the other side. So just to be clear, there's two doors. I'm assuming all of you are inside the burial chamber on the other side of that, where you came from.
There's
the urn.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm happy to go get it. I did a thing. So if someone else wants to go do a thing, they can do that. But I can go grab it. We don't want that to fall as bad if it falls.
Based on how big the urn was, like, would it take somebody with a decent amount of strength in order, or is it just
regular? No, it's large, but it's not.
Okay, I just want to go, and I'm like, oh, god damn it.
Well,
like,
Sydney
as if a lamp was about to fall over. Like,
okay. Yes, and you run around, you're able to grab the urn, you pick it up. It's fairly large, but it's not super huge.
Is there anything I notice about it as I'm holding it?
No, you grab the lid. It has that same sigil on it. It's just an urn.
Yeah. But the lid is on it.
It was off. Now it kind of slid back. It does. It's not like on it. It's not sealed, okay. But it is on the top.
So I'm just going to, okay. I want to know if I can repair the sigil. If I can.
Cool.
Yes, but it would take just from your arcane knowledge. Yes, but it would take a very powerful spell to be able to fix that sigil.
Okay. And also based on my knowledge of this thing, it is the sigil that keeps the evil inside, not the lid.
The sigil was what was binding that lid shut.
Okay. So I'm like looking at this. I want to take the urn.
Okay.
I want to keep it.
Okay. Yeah. You put it into your magical inventory, cool, in which you can fit an urn of that size. I'm deciding
no
as a
problem.
Master.
No,
level 20, I think it's fair. You got something.
Yeah. Okay. You got a bag of folding. Fuck
yeah.
It.
We're gonna hold on to this. I feel like we might run into something bad here. And so what's in that door?
I didn't explain this well. Both of the doors lead to
the same room.
Oh, to the same room. Oh,
yeah.
It's the same
thing.
I
guessed it that. Not that.
Yeah,
that
I inferred it, did not explain
inferred.
It.
Inferred. Like, that's fair. Yeah.
Well.
And then there's an additional door?
Nope.
No?
Just the two.
Okay.
And the other two open? There's nothing in the open ones either?
Yeah, they're just open caskets.
And, I just want to... we've never been in this catacomb, have we?
No.
Okay. I just want to do a quick like run through of that room and see if there are any like hidden doors or anything.
Yeah, no, it's a very sacred, very quiet, very still place, meant to be that way.
Okay.
And constructed
so,
to be that way.
Well, I guess we have to go find Nista's actual body, huh?
It seems to be the way of it.
Did you look in the urn?
Well, I mean the lid was off.
Yes.
And Talon
there was
said
nothing
that it was
in
empty.
It. Talon looked in it.
No, she's not there.
No, not in the urn. The urn had the.
Let me check.
Times you lick your hand.
Why did you do that?
I do that when I think of ideas.
God, I pressed a digitation finger.
Wait,
it's fine.
Wait, so you didn't have to lick your hand when you like cured me? You just do that? That's very unsanitary.
It's just a thing I do.
Gross.
Oh my God.
Would you? You want to hang out later?
I don't. I do want to do a hydrate, though, and I'm very sorry I don't have something to drink. I owe you, and I'll go get something in a minute.
Yeah.
Okay, so, let's see what we can find.
Is it dead end?
The real question is, who's being thanked?
Sorry?
No, said thank you. In her handwriting, in what was supposed to be her tomb, in her casket, who is she thanking?
Yeah. Seems like she would have maybe even expected to be found? Or... What? Can I see that note?
Yeah, sure.
I want to inspect the note and see how old it is.
Yeah, not.
Not very old.
Not very
old. So, almost as if this has been written...
When the DM hasn't spoken for a while, it's a bad sign.
Yeah. This is not dead.
Did she know that
this
I
is not dead?
Looks like this might be alive.
Not necessarily.
Okay.
Not necessarily.
So I wouldn't feel like it was targeted.
No.
Okay.
Oh.
I mean, to your best knowledge, she's dead.
Okay.
Oh.
This note was written recently, and we know that Nista died on... Insert time that she died.
4 to 5 years ago.
4 to 5 years ago.
Wow, Christmas. That's a long time.
3 to 5.
Sitting on the corpse.
I thought it was months. But...
Yeah, 3 to 5 months ago. It's kind of.
I think it was
gross.
Sometime.
I don't have a good timeline for this.
So they would have. The body live.
So they would have sent her body here to do the ritual to keep whatever is busted out, not busted out. And it seems like she didn't do a great job managing any of this to start. This kind of feels like a fix to me. I don't know about y'all.
Yeah.
Feels like the fix is in.
That's right. Well, let's go.
So I guess we're looking for a body, like, probably animate and dangerous, rather than, like, a corpse at this point. Makes no difference to me. I just want to make sure I know what I'm looking at.
We went to the main door.
Yep.
And then we went to the main door, and there were two doors.
Mm-hmm.
And we went through one of the doors.
Mm-hmm.
And it turned out both the doors go to the same room.
Yep.
In that mediator room, there were no other doors that we saw.
No.
And now we made it to the main room, and we don't know where to go from
yep.
here.
Yep, so at this point, from my perspective, all of you are near the urn, near the two doors, have looked around the other room. That is where we are.
All right.
Well?
There are other things we've missed. That's what you say.
I want to look around at the, I know there are torches, magically lit torches that have been there for a long time.
Sure.
I just want to look around the room.
Okay.
Like, yep.
Cool.
Perception of the,
so
of the
as
room.
You're going to walk around the room.
Yeah.
You're going to move away from the urn area, walking towards the entrance to the catacombs.
Yeah.
Great.
I don't love
so
how specific you're being
as
about
you
that. I gotta be honest.
So as you begin, I'm clarifying as a DM because that's my job. So as you start to walk away from where the urn was placed, those two doors, the torches that have been lit, from your knowledge, for centuries, start to slowly extinguish and die out. Does everyone have dark vision?
I put my goggies on.
Okay.
Yes.
The entire chambers, without your goggles, without your dark vision, becomes black as night. Everyone just roll a perception check in the new darkness.
Such a good one.
Yeah, I do. I don't know why I checked if the tiefling has dark vision.
Yeah,
I do.
Fuck, I'm
fine. What
do
we
roll?
Just
perception.
I'm so good at this.
16.
Okay.
Also 16.
Okay.
I got at least a 19.
Okay.
27, baby.
All right.
Nice.
So, Rudeus, as you're kind of exploring this chamber a little bit
it's
with Cindy.
Rudeus.
But... Rudeus. As you're exploring this chamber a little bit with Cindy, you're not exactly sure where this is emanating from, but it looks like maybe...
I grab her hand.
Yeah.
I do not
consent.
Do that.
Okay. So you go slap it away.
With that, and I double up with a mage hand.
Yeah. as you walk further in the chamber a little bit, you hear a. Almost like something's creaking from the ceiling.
No.
Talon, would you roll.
This isn't a sex thing. Please just hold my hand.
Would you roll a stealth check?
Yeah.
Fuck.
Okay. So, Talon, you're walking in this darkness, kind of surveilling the area as well. As you get to kind of the middle, the center of this very large hall that we're in.
Is this the main room, I guess?
Yeah. No, that's outside. That's outside. So you're in the just massive, essentially empty chamber other than large stone pillars.
Outside of the two doors.
Holding it up, yeah.
Yeah.
You hear a voice speak to you that says, I am Cthaeh. I am, I see, I know. At sometimes I speak. And as you try to find the direction which this voice is coming from, you look towards the very front of the chamber where you all initially entered, and you see the body of Nista just hanging in front of the door by a rope, by her neck. And her eyes are closed. As you fixate on this body, her eyes open, and she stares at you. And I will give you a reaction to that, but I need everyone to roll initiative.
Yeah, you do. Let's get it done.
Well, it's still not good.
I have no modifier.
A natural 20.
I have no modifier.
Thank you, Mad Red Raccoon.
Love you.
Mad Red Raccoon!
They just complimented my goggles.
They're good guys.
They're Miranda's.
Okay. Matt?
I have
advantage.
Hang on.
Okay.
F!
Six!
Wow. Talon?
I have five.
It's a 13 for me.
Okay. 13. All right.
Boy, if you for a guy that has advantage on initiative, I'd roll better than, you know, like a 12.
A lot of my rolls have been total shit to me.
I'm organized.
Yes! More maps! Oh.
I need a drink for this.
Your socks, man.
Yeah.
Oh, thanks.
Grab drinks. We're kind of running through this.
Okay, I'm going to go pee really quick.
Kay.
Bananas? I have no idea. Probably some kind of pepper.
It's got to be.
Definitely looks like a...
It's a cucumber.
It's something.
Why would they do tacos and cucumbers?
I have no idea.
Everyone left.
Yep. We're just doing a quick hangout sesh with some of our friends.
Whee!
It's not a break. It is a quick
just break. A potty time. We're going to see how long this takes.
It could be long.
Ow.
In the meantime, Austin, is anything you want to talk about, man?
Yeah, what's up, everybody? So, our usual stream time are on Tuesdays, if you happen to be tuning into this. Tuesdays! We usually get going around 7 o'clock-ish Mountain Standard Time. I don't know time math at the moment, so I don't know where that might be in your area. Plus, I don't know your area. Anyway...
Really talk to me.
Tune in on Tuesdays on Twitch on our regular stuff. In fact, just follow us and you'll know whenever we go live and stuff. Also, subscribe to our tubes. We got the tubes going where you can catch up on all the episodes of the Bottlecap Brigade. You're tuned in right now to a special one-shot where we take a one-shot and accidentally make it a who-the-fuck-knows shot.
It's gonna be three.
It's fucking So, yeah, thank you so much for tuning in. And if you like what you see, hit the follow button and subscribe to our YouTube shits. Also, our Patreon is getting a revamping and is going to go live August 1st with the new and improved party times. Cheers.
Cheers.
Yeah. I'll drink that.
Fuck this guy every time, man.
Don't
fuck this guy every time.
Fuck this guy all the time.
That was really
Mary,
hot.
Did you know?
Hot and bothered.
I know exactly what song you're singing.
What? We grew up in Christian homes.
Hey, now I worship the devil.
Hey. Sometimes you go from left to right, you know?
Fuck God.
Sometimes you go
just
from
up to down.
Just it... don't make any color references in your song.
Sometimes you go. Oh, well.
Is it the ball devil? Don't worship the ball devil. He sucks.
All right, so this actually worked out really well. Talon, you go first in combat. So instead of giving you any sort of reaction to this, you have an action on. What you can tell is Nisa's corpse. We're gonna use the same fucking shit. I'm so sorry.
That's cool.
I meant to get this map printed, but we will say that we are all here, and then this is about a 100-yard chamber, and she is a pretty good distance away at this point.
Ooh, this is bad, wrong.
What?
This is a bad situation.
Yeah. It's not good.
That's Nista?
Yep.
You had all the options to really put some, like...
It's the little minis that like are
it's
like
blue green
that'll get
beautiful.
You right.
It's actually the most frightening thing you put on that table.
Yeah.
She's a human shaped thing.
Like human.
She's a human
shaped thing.
Human shaped. Oh, see, that's what.
Can't really tell the material it's built out of. Okay, as soon as she opens up
Magic
her
missile.
Eyes, and Talon like makes eye contact with her, she's gonna pull out both of her daggers. Into the darkness, and it's just gonna say fuck you, and it's just gonna go running for her and just try to like she's not a barbarian, but she's just gonna rage on her.
Okay,
her body.
We're gonna use some DM leverage here, and we're gonna say even though she's a vast grip of distance past your typical movement range because of the situation and your anger, you reach it.
Okay.
So,
wow. Here, I can fastball special you like Colossus.
Yes.
If you want to give her a boost, you can.
And
yeah.
I
can,
like, throw your weapon?
Yeah. I'm just going to pick you up and just, like.
Yeah. Chuck her, dude.
Oh, totally. Dope. Fuck yes.
Let's make it.
And to, like, extend, like, pause out and then, like, very
yeah,
last
yeah.
minute to, like,
chucks the cat.
Roll athletics.
Listen, I might throw you too far. It's the thing of this.
And you need to know this, but it says halfling fighter underneath.
That's...
Oh, I know, and it's totally not that.
Let me do a little
math
here.
They just kind of have similar, like,
this in the beginning,
yeah,
so,
they have
yeah.
similar like feats to the cat folks.
23.
Okay, yeah, that works really well.
Okay.
You just kind of. Just baseball pitcher
just.
Up there. You roll out of this like a champ. And get right up into her. Roll a constitution saving throw as you get within 30 feet.
Okay, hold on. I have something for con that I have not been adding that I found. Let me figure it out really quick.
I'm probably dead last, so.
That's okay. 27.
Okay.
Lucky number.
You barely broke that. So you take...
Barely, That's disheartening.
Eight. 2, 5...
Oh, okay.
11. 19. 23 points of necrotic damage.
Okay.
Oh, no, sorry, I'm dumb. I'm so dumb. 11 points of necrotic damage.
What's 23 minus 11?
12 points of necrotic. I halved it. Can't do math.
I know, I'm just adding it.
Do we know... who all heard Cthaeh speak? Only Miranda?
Yeah.
Okay.
It was telepathic.
Sweet.
Yeah, so you're up in her face.
Okay, great. I'm just gonna go all four attacks. I'm gonna go for like the stomach region and just try to like rip out her innards.
Okay.
Go ahead and swing all four.
A little what do you call it? Disembowelment.
Yeah.
Yes.
That's always fun.
Wow, this headphones. Okay, I'm gonna say I think the first attack is 26. I think I had 11. Yep, okay, so first attack is 26. Yes. 30. Ooh, the second, third one definitely doesn't hit. Okay, and then 22.
Okay. That, so those three all hit.
Okay.
All right, and where, what are you looking? Are you looking, like, in her eyes, or are you looking at where you're swinging? I just need a bit of context.
No, I'm actually looking straight at, okay. to where I'm.
I didn't know if you broke eye contact.
Yeah.
Not a big deal either way.
Jesus. Okay, I got my three blades on. Woo! Okay. 12, 50, 40, 15,
18.
That's
a lot of dice you get to roll. I'm
19.
Very proud of you.
Oh my god, okay. I'm gonna need a calculator for this.
Sorry.
No, 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 it's great. I love this. 19 plus 12 plus 2. Okay. Plus 9 plus 4. Okay, 61 points of damage.
Doom!
And for the, I was just, like, tripped backwards.
That amazing. like, so I hope you'll be okay after that.
So I don't even be worth the joke. So I've, like, dug my, like, I've crossed my arms and dug my daggers into, like, her, like, lower stomach. And I just go, poof, poof. And I'm just gonna try and, like, almost just, like, with three movements, try and just like carve her out. And for the hit that I miss, can I spit in her face?
Yeah.
Okay, so like here, here, and then my right before my last like slash of her, I'm just gonna spit in her face and then finish my move.
Okay, so as you spit into her face, you look into her eyes. Okay. You can't not
okay.
do that.
Okay.
You can tell, and with your really familiar knowledge, Tanisa, you two are friends, she's reading your mind at this point. And any attacks that you make on her until your next turn, so like your next turn,
okay.
has disadvantage.
Okay.
Unless you're able to break her gaze.
She sees you coming.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hey, Talon, what's going on with Nista, huh? What's the deal?
Rip her apart.
Okay.
And so, to be clear, all of you are quite a distance away at this point. Nista and Talon are locked together near the entry of this catacombs. It is now Nista's turn, and with that, we're going to end the session.
Whoa! Oh, shit!
Chills I got.
Mid boss fight.
Okay.
Damn.
Does she become a god?
Okay.
Is she Cthaeh? Is she Nista? Tune in next time to find out.
Thank you all so much
Nobody
at home
knows.
For watching this. This is going to be. I'm sorry I dragged this one shot into a three shot.
I don't know
when the last iteration of this is going to be, but it's going to be at a time in which is convenient for all four of you. And it will be a very short thing.
And then we can chat about it afterwards.
And then we can have a debrief. Austin can maybe make up some lore on the point about how this actually connects to real-life Magna time.
That'll be fun.
I gave you a lot of creative freedom, and now I'm concerned about it.
How I'm tying this together, I think you'll be happy.
It's been fun getting to be a part of, build a part of the world.
Yeah. You totally are, though, Matt. Like...
Yeah.
Not, I want to say this. Not only are you part of the world, but you're like totally a part of the group. You're our dude, for sure.
And that's all we got. Thank you again, Matt, for joining. Follow and love his Twitter and YouTube and content.
Yeah, That Baseball Show. Add That BB Show on Twitter or That Baseball Show wherever you download podcasts. We're going to record another one Monday. We'll have that out at the beginning, like middle of the week. Can I say this here? Because we know this for sure. Those of you who are locals to where the Bottlecap Brigade resides, That Baseball Show is actually going to be at the Shreveport Music Fest. Assuming that still happens, fingers crossed.
Yeah, well.
Is
it not?
I mean, you know, Delta. I don't know. But anyway, we're planning on it. The Friday, or I think it's a Friday of Treefort. We'll be there at 6 o'clock or so.
Yeah.
Doing a live show.
Here
so
Boise,
that's going to be
music festival.
Pretty radical. Yeah. For those of you who are not here, sorry about your life. But, it's going to be great.
Sorry, they live in a better place with other cool things.
Yeah, I'm sure it's all good. But,
anyway, in Montana.
We'll be on our social media channels. We'll be blasting that out as well. But, like, we're really looking forward to that, being back live with people. So, come chill. Come hang out at that BB show on Twitter, That Baseball Show.
Yeah.
Blast you out.
Yeah.
All right. You're great. Love you. Bye.
All right. See you guys.